Hello.
Hi.
Hello, Keith.
It's so funny that we always have about 10 minutes of totally good audio before Jack puts us live.
Yeah, well, you know, we just, it's fun to just talk as friends, you know?
Yeah,
I don't
want
to bring, it's like the Mitch Hedberg joke where he says, I don't want to bring ink and paper into this.
Yeah. That's the second time that's come up recently. That's funny.
Yeah, when did it come up before? In a merch meeting or something?
Yeah, maybe that's what it was. Yeah, that's what it was. That's what it was.
God, I heard a new Mitch Hedberg joke recently. I heard a guy on a podcast who knew Mitch Hedberg.
I think I shared this with you. Well,
you
not with you, but I think
was?
I put it in the... Yeah, I do remember what it was.
Because it's great.
It's that he didn't carry credit cards. He just carried cash, and he was trying to rent a hotel room, and he tried to pay in cash, like way overpay. And they're like, no, we only take credit cards. And he was like, no, this should cover it. And they're like, no, we need a credit card on file. And he's like, but this is what the credit card represents.
He has like an analogy, right? He's like saying this would be like if you did X. God,
I don't remember the analogy off the top of my head. I think it's it's like an actor thing, like this actor type, and the person comes in, or like maybe it's the same thing, but like a musician, like you like hire a Bob Dylan impersonator Dylan shows up. He's like, no, I hired an impersonator.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
Yeah, yeah.
God, my favorite Mitch Hedberg joke is, man, it would suck to be killed by an arrow.
Yeah.
All the guys drop and went, he must have gone that way.
Just a delight to listen to. It's hard to pick
just
a favorite.
Just a delight.
Yeah.
God, you've seen his Comedy Central taping or something where the crowd isn't on board at the start of the set and they spend the first like 40 minutes not really vibing with Mitch Hedberg, and he gradually brings them around until the end where he's like, all right, let's just roll it around. I'm going to do all the jokes for the first half of the set again.
That's really funny. I don't know if I've seen that. That's really good.
It's fun. I mean, it's weird watching a Mitch Hedberg show and being like, you fucking idiots in the audience. You know what you had.
I always loved his special that has the double bass player in the background just sort of grooving. That was always my favorite.
Yeah.
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 And I always thought more comedians should have that. More comedians should have a tonally appropriate backing band.
If you want to, I'll be the bassist and you'll be the comedian.
In general,
stand up. No, I mean like when we still do our show.
Sure. Yeah, I was just making sure that you weren't saying that I should start doing stand up right now, because I would say I'm not prepared to do that.
No. And it's a different kind of thing, right? I'm sure you'd be very good at it, but you do want to come into it knowing what you're going to say.
Right. I've done it before a couple times, a few times, handful of times. It's fun. It's really nerve wracking. I mean,
I imagine
it's tremendously. I've done it where I felt so nervous, and then like I talked to people that I knew who swore that I was not visibly nervous, and I'm like, I can't tell if they're just being nice, but
yeah,
I felt visibly nervous anyway.
It sucks to feel visibly nervous. And,
yes,
you know, it's not something that, and I mean, maybe it does pass quickly for some people, but you know, sometimes you're nervous. And you only have to be brave for 15 seconds, you know?
Right, yeah.
But when you're doing stand-up, you're nervous and you have to be brave for the set.
Yeah, yeah, which was like 8 minutes.
Throughout.
Like that's the most I've ever done is like 8 minutes.
Yeah, and you know, you see like full hour and a half long stand-up specials and you're like, Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
How do they do that?
That was like my first big inspiration. And for many, many years, like... the thing that I identified as like my artistic inspiration was stand-up comedy. And I feel like I've moved past that. But I still do respect it and love it.
Do you like
even when only in theory
stand-up?
That's a tough question, because the answer is sort of no, but I also don't really like seeing live music that much either. despite loving music.
Huh.
Which is I feel like is abnormal.
Yeah, I mean, Kat doesn't really like sort of stadium shows, but sort of like seeing live music generally, and I like both. I don't know. No, I think I like both.
There's two things. I have a hard time surrendering to the vibe of a live show. Is one problem, and then the other problem is I really love the presentation of like, prepare me what you want to show me, which I understand you also have to prepare for a live show, but I'm like, you know, like finish your product at like the way you'd like and then give it to me, like finished.
Yeah. Yeah.
And maybe that's why I've always connected to Steely Dan so much, because they were like, forget the live shows and the Beatles. They both were like, forget the live shows. Let's just do this. The painstakingly, neurotically intense way that we want to, and then release it as a finished
thing. It's going to be really annoying for you if I try and do this, do what I want to do now.
Yeah.
So you're going to have to listen to my album instead.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to play Crusader Kings?
Yes,
Before we get started, I want to sort of begin the stream by acknowledging how awful the news is today. Atrocities that we're seeing coming out of Gaza and occupied Palestine. And I'm doing this in part because I think it would be exceptionally glib to sit down and yuck our way through a game of Crusader Kings without acknowledging at the beginning how rough things are right now. I stand with, and I'm sure I can speak for Keith and the rest of the crew, in absolute solidarity with the people of Palestine against the nightmare that they are facing right now. And I would like to invite people to donate, if you're able, to charities such as Medical Aid for Palestinians, which you can find at map.org.uk. I hope we see a free Palestine in our lifetime.
Yeah. Other places, Palestine Children's Relief Fund, Medical Aid for Palestinians. I've heard like different things about Palestine Red Crescent, but those are just three other places to look into.
You
know, everywhere needs it.
Yep. So I wanted to begin with that. And now we can return to Gerhardt in the Holy Roman Empire. Let me just tab over here. I'm on the menu because I wanted to save the experience of loading into the game for the stream. I wanted to show you the little note that we made for ourselves here, Keith. We've made it very clear. Do you see our new plan?
Get Silvermine and invade Hungary. Great. We really set ourselves up because we did the exact same thing at the end of the last recording, which was like we spent 5 minutes outlining everything that we wanted to do.
Yeah.
I went back and read I watched a little bit of the video, but I was like, oh, I have a great idea. Let me open up the auto-generated captions and just control F.
I've been doing that. Yeah.
Wow.
For other videos. It's super helpful.
It's not something that occurred to me until a couple weeks ago when I needed to do it for something. And I'm really glad I finally thought of it.
Specifically hear the bit where you and I went through the entirety of the song The Joker by the Steve Miller Band.
What did we do?
We basically sang The Joker by the Steve Miller Band.
Okay. To what end?
I don't know.
Okay.
We saw a guy, and I think you said some people call me Maurice. And at that point, you know,
it was
sort of done. But yes, we did the equivalent of going away on the game crashed.
Oh, fun.
We did the equivalent of going away on vacation and having made our bed beforehand. So we returned to find that we know exactly what we need to do.
I thought that you were saying I thought that this was going to be the literal real life thing, but we haven't played since going away on vacation.
We haven't, have we?
No, we haven't.
We haven't played I've Moved House in the meantime.
Yeah.
I watched these streams while I was moving house.
That's so fun.
As I was packing up the house, I was watching these streams. It was very pleasant. Because, and I'm sure that the viewer feels the same way. Crusader Kings is so dense that you can kind of just put it on in the background, and whether or not you're listening to it, you can tune in at any moment and something bananas will be happening.
This is something that I've, I feel like this has been my project as someone who talks over video games for over a decade, which is like to have a very long, sometimes relevant to the game conversation over a video game while people who are listening can easily watch the whole thing intently or not.
Yeah. Absolutely. Especially because I feel that when we make friends at the table, it's like, you better be fucking focusing, bud.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I couldn't be more paying attention to friends at the table, and I still have no idea what I did or what anyone else did.
Oh, God. Okay.
You already know this, but someone sent in a correction to Austin about the Divine Commitment and whose idea it was. And I was on the episode where Austin said that Dre came up with it, and I said nothing, and I thought nothing about it. And then someone was like, no, that was Keith's idea. I literally went and checked because I didn't believe it. And I was like, yep, here it is, right in the transcripts. I did this.
Sometimes
how many years ago?
Yeah, sometimes I will read through a transcript or I'll see a quote or something, and I will go, oh, that sounds sick. I wish I'd come up with that. And I'll look it up, and I did. Or, alternatively, I'll be like, I'm not really vibing with that. Who came up with that? And it was me. I was the one who came up with it.
It is. I've had, again, a long time to get used to this, and I haven't. I have no qualms with it, but it is funny every time it happens and kind of odd. Essentially, no offense to everyone listening, strangers who know my life in a lot of ways better than I do.
Yes, it is a very, very odd, feeling.
Yeah. It's helpful. It's only ever helped me.
Yeah. Now, of course, my cloud saves are not actually available, but I think the autosave exit that I made is the one we want.
Sure. Yeah, I believe it.
Let's see. Yes, because now Alsace, right, as you can tell, is here in Sardinia.
Is that the silver mine?
No, the silver mine is down here in Arborea.
Okay, so we're one away. Okay,
Cagliari.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
So that is one of the things that we needed to do.
Yeah, all right. Do we want to do like a quick recap?
Yes.
Since it has been a while.
So and we can fill in the gaps where each other has gaps. The thing that I remember is being extremely, extremely hated by the Pope and the Church, having super low piety, going on a very successful pilgrimage, and then the Pope offering multiple big important titles to us, including for the Kingdom of Hungary.
Yes, and now you might have noticed Hungary is over here and it's fucking massive.
it is not close to Alsace in any way. But you know, why not?
Yeah.
And the other thing that we wanted to do was, take over the silver mine that is in, what is it? Cagliari?
It's either in Cagliari or in Arborea. Yeah. It's in one of these two. I think it's in Cagliari.
I think you're right. Because that is and we have a sort of broad project because we can no longer, wage intervassal war within the Holy Roman Empire to pluck as many of these cherries as we can from that are like unaffiliated in and around the Holy Roman Empire, especially in Italy.
Yes. So we are playing Duke Gerhard, who is this fellow. He is 42 years old. He has many venereal diseases.
Can you read the names of every single one of our children?
Yeah, absolutely I can. Although the game has frozen.
What is going on with your stuff tonight?
I have no idea. I put up a new desk today. And so I think, I have to imagine that
Could you have bumped something in there?
No, I hope not. God, I hope not.
Oh, there you go.
There we go. Okay, yeah. So we are Duke Gearhart. We have 6 children. They are called Heilvig, who is going to be our heir. She's 25 years old. Anno, Grundin, Maluz, Hunman, and little baby Gottfried, who is 0. We started out the game in as a very lowly person in Alsace here in the Holy Roman Empire, and made a few gains internally in Sundgau and in Strasbourg, sort of working our way up to the Duke tier. And then we learned something really spectacular, which is that because of how our religion and culture works, and I think because of the way certain laws have been passed, we have a casus belli, we have a reason to go to war. Or like a legitimate reason to go to war with any neighboring country. Right, Keith?
Correct.
And because the Holy Roman Empire is absolutely gigantic, neighboring countries crop up as far north as Denmark, as far south as North Africa. We haven't gone too far east yet, although things are looking pretty good in Hungary. So we're learning very quickly that we have a degree of latitude in terms of who we can invade that we didn't really think we had. And it's especially good because
part of the latitude is that we very quickly went from being an absolute peanut of a count to having a sort of outsized strength for our size. I think we happen to have no money and fairly low prestige, but we're doing pretty well for ourselves and doing it pretty quickly. I mean, we've only been at this for what, like 20 years,
maybe something like that.
30
yeah.
years? No, it wouldn't have been 30 years because
we're not old enough.
Our guy's only 42.
Yeah, yeah, we've been doing this for about 20 years.
Yeah,
which is just fascinating. Yeah. So we have, you know. We have some options here. We can declare 7 wars, which is brilliant. We need to start talking about this in a second, but that's okay. We'll be fine.
Our hostage thing? Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, our hostage situation. We can go to war with the Hungarians, because not only are we sort of able to go to war with Hungary, we have a strong claim on Hungary.
Right, we were given a strong claim by the Pope.
Yes. Whereas these places here in the Hamadid Emirate and in Kairun and in Balam, you know, these North African countries to the south, we don't have as strong a claim, but we can still invade due to this sort of neighboring country type thing.
Mm-hmm.
Here we can attack Cagliari and Arborea. We have a really capable army to do this. This should absolutely be our next step. And then Ermentrude of Besançon. Now, this is really interesting, Keith, because I thought that with the High Crown
Great
Authority...
Great pronunciation there, by the way.
Oh, thank you very much. I didn't think we were able to wage internal wars.
It's true, but we must have had a pre-existing or...
Oh, she is independent. I have no idea what that's about.
We must have a pre-existing casus belli, or maybe there's some other reason why. Oh, there was another place that the Pope gave us a title for. Because we got a place and yeah, there we go. Yeah. So we have a pre-existing claim probably to the third tier. What is it called? The crown authority, three crown authority, or it's the Pope. And I'm pretty sure it's the Pope.
I think it's the Pope. We have a pretty.
I've missed this game. I have a big game that I was playing. I love this game so much that I started playing alongside us playing.
Yeah.
A separate thing.
Yeah.
And I stopped playing that. I should get back to that.
Where's your current save? Are you still working on Big Portugal?
Oh, it's massive. It's bigger than ever. I mentioned it at the end of last episode, but doing some tricky marriage maneuvers paired with some precise murdering, I was able to have my heir inherit in a matrilineal marriage all of the Francia Empire.
That's amazing.
It was phenomenal. All of a sudden, overnight, I quadrupled the land that I owned.
That's just extraordinary. Okay, so thanks to someone in chat who has pointed out the economy map, this is a very beautiful map.
Wow.
Doesn't this map look delicious?
Yes.
This is peach flavored. This is watermelon.
All the yellow is like a delicious lemon custard.
Yum. That's brilliant. So this shows county income and special buildings. So we can see right off the bat.
Silver mine, there we go.
The paler ones give you more, the darker ones give you less. But we are looking for the Argentiera mining settlement. The Argentaria di Sigiero is rich in underground silver veins. With sufficient incentive and development, this area could be exploited for vast quantities of precious silver.
It will nearly double our gold intake.
Yeah, absolutely. Also, let me just... Where is Hungary?
Sorry, actually, even better than that. It will double our net gold, because 3.5 is our net gold. It will double our net
gold. I have to go back here and see where Hungary is. Hungary is here. Now that I've learned about this economy view, I'm just like, Okay, Hungary is not tremendously wealthy, but the Torda mining pits seem pretty good. Oh, yeah, that is good. Look at that.
Look at that.
Damn. Okay, so I think our number one priority should probably be war with Cagliari. Now, we could go through Arborea first, but my guess is we just invade Cagliari and then...
Just go right around it. We border it.
Yeah.
We can become a mouth that swallows Arborea up.
Wait. Oh, they're off to go to Bologna.
Our kids are always playing.
They're always going off to play, and that's allowed. And when one of them goes, all the...
My.
Have a good time.
Good my. Do we have a child whose name is blank space?
Who is my? No.
Because that's what it says. Have a good time, comma, nothing. It's the name of the child that's supposed to be there.
Nothing will happen. Gerhard is just at home going, what would happen if I sent someone off to play?
Just gotta turn my...
I don't know.
Turn my hello, test. There we go. That's better.
Hello. Well, hi. Off you go, my. Something that we could do, actually, that we learned, right, Keith, is that we can... These places form part of a duchy, the Duchy of Sardinia.
Yeah.
And we can create it if we take Arborea.
Yeah, right.
But we don't have the money for it yet. So we should just...
No, but Arborea or what's it called? Cagliari will give us the money faster.
Yes, that's true.
So we should do that plan. We should get the one with the gold first.
Yes. Ozzy Damien says, isn't this save from before the Warden Warden's update? Probably explains why the child events are bugged. Yes, this save came in before the update that focused on child rearing.
Can you not update? Is that a new save update?
No, I'm all updated. I think it's just a bug that was introduced by the fact that this game was created beforehand. I think we have all that stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. It's just, you know, not really in there yet.
Because we started playing just right after a major update. So I thought that it included the Warden Warden stuff.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I could be wrong.
Now let's see. Okay. So that will cost us 675 prestige, but.
Which we don't have.
What about a forced vassalization?
Okay.
That's merely 225 prestige.
Yes. We will barely not be able to afford that. I think that we should maybe try and have an event, a prestige. No, because we don't have the money to do that. It's hard to know. Should we go negative prestige or should we sit and wait?
Now, we could go to war here with Judaic Torbenu.
Okay. And going to war will give us prestige when we win.
Which we will, so, because we have 4,000 soldiers and they have 542.
Yeah, so the net on this will be will swing pretty hard in our favor, I think. I say go for it.
Yeah, yeah. And this is a vassalization war, so he will become our vassal and hate it.
Yeah.
But we'll
deal
with
that. And he's not, this is not the same, the Cagliari and Arborea, they're not connected, right? So we won't be signing a peace treaty with...
No, they are not connected.
Okay, perfect. Beautiful.
He doesn't actually have a leash. This is like easy pickings for us.
Right, yeah. Yes, yeah. This is barely... This will barely register for us.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, raise everybody here. Everybody's gonna show up. Our wife is the commander. Don't worry about that.
I have it's not probably not worth it.
Apparently we need to hold it directly to get a money benefit. Hold Cagliari. Well, we'll get some of it, right, actually.
Is there a reason why we wouldn't hold it directly?
If it was a vassalization war.
Oh, okay.
So if it's a vassalization war, we only get a percentage from the vassal.
Yeah, but once we hold 2 out of 3 of the counties in the duchy, the ducal war cost will plummet, I think.
Yes, I think so. But we should, and I think we talked about this, we should take Cagliari for ourselves. Absolutely.
Yeah.
You know, that's ours. Because we have room for one more, too. The first time it happened, I barely even gave it a moment's thought, but my vassal, Count Marianu, who fucking despises us for some reason.
Right.
This man hates us.
Well, he's a fearless antagonist, that's why.
This man, who the hell is this guy? He's from...
Oh, he's the count of the place that we're staging this war from. Now know why he hates us.
Oh.
Because we just took him over.
I figured it out. His challenges no longer pass unnoticed among my vassals. He's testing his limits. So my options here are we could mock him, which is very funny. We could give him tasks which are impossible to complete. We could...
Yes, that's the one.
Say he's got a big dick. We could we could just be angry with him.
He's diligent, so giving him tasks that are impossible to complete will fuck him over.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So Keith's doing this by looking at his traits here and sort of guessing. Okay, let's do it. He shall have tasks which are impossible to complete. And it became daytime and he got a building behind him.
Oh, I guess he did build that building.
Let's see.
There we go.
Oh, brilliant. He will think twice before challenging me again.
And look at that, 79, minus 79. He likes us a little bit more because
look at this coy little man.
Yeah. He looks like we did talk about his codpiece.
Yeah, but in fact we didn't. We just made him build a building, maybe.
Right.
Okay, you will probably win. Yeah, I fucking think so.
I see. We didn't call our allies to this war. That's why. We shouldn't, by the way. We should just beat them with who we actually have.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm going to send Avamai, our spymaster, to find secrets in Cagliari.
Find secrets or create a claim there?
The bishop would be the one to create the claim, and that costs money, which we don't have.
Oh, right. You're exactly right.
However... Someone has just arrived at our court who has a claim on the grand city of Pisa.
Oh, well, that will also cost money, but it's worth at least pinning them.
Yeah. Let's see. Courtiers.
Oh, excellent from Zutaka to deal with our hostages. We might be able to get some.
Ooh. Yes.
Oh, we have no prisoners. These are someone else's hostages, I guess. We can offer hostages. What does that mean? I can demand a hostage? I don't know what this means. I've never seen it put like that in the game, is why I'm...
Whoa, we can give them our people?
Oh, why?
Why?
This is a weird war thing?
Hostages may deter or neutralize threats, allowing you to focus your attention elsewhere and grant monthly prestige to the warden. Well, I don't want them. However... we could demand a hostage from Bertolt.
Okay. This is who we... Did we just embarrass Bertolt? No, from Zurich. No, never mind. Will accept. You will earn prestige. Why...
This is a new mechanic for the War of Wards and Wardens.
Bizarre.
This is
bizarre.
30 Terracites are swapping kids as a war deterrent. That's absolutely what it is, right?
Wow. Wow. That's phenomenal.
Don't need any of that. You can
this is something we've talked about. Oh, did we not want to do that?
No, I don't want to put more pieces on the board in a way that might not be useful for us right now.
Well, I was thinking that the thing that was useful is getting the prestige from having the hostage because we're low prestige right now.
Okay, well,
we could probably go to Zurich, find that guy and right click and demand hostage. I'm sure that would work.
Yeah, let's see. Zurich,
this is the thing we I've talked about this before. It's something I've talked about on Run Button, something that we've talked about in this Let's Play. But the thing that is so fascinating about Crusader Kings is the way that it asks you, the way that it makes you, simply by playing this game, into a tyrant. It really, it pulls you into the way that a ruler of the world sees the world, which is, you know, pieces on a map and numbers to raise and lower, people to kill. It is extremely and necessarily dehumanizing, to so easily go like, oh my God, we can kidnap this kid and get prestige every month. That's awesome.
Yeah. Let's see. This is Waldo becomes our hostage, and he comes to our court. Wardens at war with home courts may freely execute hostages. Home courts and wardens suffer penalties for attacking each other. So we're basically saying nobody attack anybody. It's like an insurance method. So yeah, let's do that. You can change Count Marianu's contract. Count Marianu is that guy we just humiliated. And he also doesn't like us because we're not his rightful liege. We'll fix that problem when we...
Yeah. When we declare ourselves the Duke.
Yes. However, we could ask for more... Okay. Well, shit. That is tyranny.
Sorry, why are... it's tyranny, but you have to click the use a hook button.
Oh.
There we go.
Oh. Okay. Yeah. Well, while we're here... Okay, no. It has to be...
It's just one. We can just change one. Yeah. They're very serious about that. You can only ever change one during the life of a vassal.
Okay.
So in order to change it again, even if we had another hook, they would have to die.
This guy hates us anyway.
Right.
But we could get 0.1 more stuff. So why not?
Hey, the more the merrier.
The more the merrier, the money.
And once control is up and that guy doesn't hate us so much, that 0.1, that might be a 0.3. So
yeah, speaking of control, I do actually want to check really quickly. So our marshal is increasing control in the county Colmar. Colmar, it's not great, but it's getting there.
It's getting there.
And we want control because it boosts the levies of all kinds.
It boosts the levies and it lowers events like peasant uprisings. It increases gold. Lots of good comes from popular opinion being high and control being high.
Bertolt, send me Waldo.
Nice.
Great. We will earn prestige. Lovely. Riding through the streets of Strasbourg, having dealt with some trivial errand in the town, my entourage and I hear a loud crash. A little investigation shows it was some burger or other throwing a clay pot from their window, uncaring of whether it might hit someone below. Callous, yes, but what can you expect? At any rate, it's hardly something worth much further thought. Those peons. Okay.
That could have hurt someone.
That's concerning. Oh, well.
Do you think that was an assassination attempt?
Oh, shit. I wonder if it was.
I think that might have been an assassination attempt.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, didn't work. Who's trying to kill me?
I don't know. Maybe we should discover some secrets in our court.
In our court, yeah. I want this to finish because it would be great to have a hook on the guy who runs Cagliari.
True.
And we have my siege weapons here, so this siege is going okay.
Yeah, 10 months, that's about typical.
Waldo has arrived. We're like, it's all good. We'll be mates. Nobody's going to get hurt. Someone did just try and kill me. Don't worry.
But don't worry about it. And it wasn't your dad, I bet.
Oh, there's an election in the HRE.
Do you think we have a shot? Be honest.
Okay, you are not one of the electors and cannot vote.
No, we are a candidate, though. No votes, but we are a candidate.
Yeah. Yeah.
Looks like it's the Duke is running away with it.
Duke Dietrich of Upper Lorraine.
Oh, someone else has 5 also.
There's 36 candidates. Duke Herman? No, King Vratislav?
And Duke Herman both have 5.
Oh, because it's also based on their vote strength. Huh.
Huh.
Yeah.
Oh, is that what that is? That's not votes. That's vote.
This is votes. Oh, okay, this is their total score.
Sure. Which is different than votes because some people have bigger vote scores.
Yes, yes. There are 36 candidates. Nobody has voted for me. Which sucks. While we are here, we should designate a guardian for Waldo. And the guardian for Waldo should be me. Great. We should also employ a wet nurse, maybe. But it's probably good. We have a baby.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Okay, we can probably, or do we wait until we have a bit more money to employ a wet nurse? Probably wait until we have a bit more money.
Yeah, I think
we don't
wait.
Want them to arrive and just get, like, awful lady.
Yeah, I agree.
Okay. Right. This siege continues. He fled up north to Tuscany, which is interesting, but it's not going to help him.
No, and that's really the when you lose a battle, it just forces you to retreat, and it's the game chooses the direction. I don't know really based on what. So it's probably they were forced to flee up there because it was the only place to go. And now we're headed back down here.
Now, Duke Dietrich.
Sure.
Duke Dietrich is requiring us to send Herman to his court as a hostage.
Herman, no, of course we won't do that.
No, absolutely not. Are you the spymaster of...
No, we're the spymaster of...
No. One of the dukes is the spymaster of the Kaiser.
Oh, sorry, we're the regent of the Kaiser.
Yes. How do we see the court of other people?
I don't remember.
Do we do it? Liege's Council. Here we go. The spymaster is Duke Herman, and the person who wants our son is Duke Dietrich. Absolutely not. No. What is block answer? Huh. Not gonna happen. I think they might be coming back for a second go. This siege is going well.
Do you know what happens when the Kaiser finds the Fountain of Youth?
What? Well, what does happen when the Kaiser finds the Fountain of Youth?
Becomes a Kaiser Permanente.
Whoa! Wait! That's a little American healthcare meets immortal Holy Roman Emperor joke. To the vile Duke Gerhard, we have been burdened with your oppressive laws for so long. We're done paying your taxes. Once your coffers dry up and your larders are empty, you will wish you had treated us more fairly. I will not grant you a tax, Lien. And every county in the faction... Oh, it's a faction. I'm not worried. You guys want to do a peasant uprising? Fucking fine. Good luck.
We can actually probably take, because they're about to spawn in, right?
The peasants?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're probably going to spawn in up here. Yeah, here they are.
Is that them? So we could, free of charge, we can get our allies to quash that for us so that we don't have to divert our attention.
Oh, can we?
Yeah.
Huh. Okay. Because
it's a defensive war. Allied rulers hate peasant uprisings, if you can believe it.
Okay, yeah, absolutely. Would you like to deal with my peasant uprising? It's free and you'll have a great time. Love it.
Who was that we called? I didn't recognize who it was.
It was Count Reynard of Dole. Who's coming in? I think they might have just killed my marshal. I don't know. That can't be right.
Let's check. If they killed our marshal... No, we've still got a marshal. Look at that.
He just can't increase county control right now because... the hell is happening over here?
How many troops does our ally that we call have?
745.
Oh, is that enough? Should be enough, right?
Yeah. Reynard has joined. Oh, the kids have come back from... from hanging out.
That's
Count
great.
Ugo's.
We've been at war since you've been away.
Indeed.
You've missed a heck of a war.
Ooh, we won the Battle of Arborea. I guess they came down for another fight and we beat them again. And
we captured
his knight, Aelgus.
Wow.
Great.
That's great. After the war, we can get a little coin from that.
Maluz has come of age.
Poor Maluz.
I know. No, poor Maluz. Oh dear, this magnanimous villain. He has an excellent grasp of all manners of etiquette. What's his? Oh, he has pretty good. Average, but he's also 16 years old. So that's not
right. Those will get a bump when he's. What is the other one? What is that beehive?
He's irritable.
What is that irritable? Oh, it's okay. Beehive. Got it.
Yeah, his diplomacy is good. Yeah,
nice.
Very happy with this.
Yeah.
Low county control in Colmar. Has this peasant uprising been... Ah, yes. Okay, we'll just enforce these demands. Nobody's going to exchange hostages. At all. But I will imprison the leader. To the rattling Gerhard, may your years be short and miserable. I know when I am defeated. Okay.
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 Maybe we can ransom some people now.
Yeah, great idea.
Hey, Marshall.
Wait, he just died of old age.
He died in his sleep of old age. Look at that, 59.
Huh, okay.
Heck of a guy.
Heck of a guy.
Heck of a guy.
New vassal, and it's new Marshall is the excellent Mayor Benedictor of Schleichstadt.
We should sort just in case, sort by Marshall. That's probably the highest, but yeah, there we go.
Yeah. And she doesn't like us very much, but she will like us in a bit.
She'll like us a little bit more, yeah.
In fact, she thinks we are now okay.
Yeah, neutral.
Where is she based? She's based in Schleichstadt, which is... Oh, just... Wait. Where is it? Oh, it's in Strasbourg? Yes, it's the city of Strasbourg. She's the mayor, and she hates us for some reason.
Wow.
But, you know... That's all good.
Yeah. All right. Let's check our prisoners and check back in on the fight here.
Yep. Sounds great. Let's see. Give me my prisoners. We have two. We have Cunegund von Scharfenberg, who I can ransom for a hook.
What's her stats like? Maybe we can recruit her when we have some money. Keep her in the prison until 26. Holy.
Whoa.
Wow.
Whoa.
Peasant leader, how about work for meter?
Peasant leader, work for meter? Yeah. Okay, yeah, let's do it. Okay, look, lady.
I have bad news for the mayor.
I'm going to recruit you.
Wait, we should gain we cook. We should not gain we cook because...
Just recruit.
Yeah, just recruit because she'll hate us.
Okay. This is going to be a really confusing time for her. Okay. I want you to disrupt schemes in my court. Find... Whoops.
Oh, hey, we just won the thing. We should pause it before we get in this fight.
Yeah. Nice. Find secrets in... my court, which is... I've lost Strasbourg. Here it is. Cool. Or do we have him on disrupt schemes? Let's have him on disrupt schemes. Okay, we've won that. That's done.
This war is probably over.
Yeah, I think it... Yeah.
Yeah, there we go.
Let's enforce demands. Nobody exchanges hostages.
Can we click on the demand thing?
Ooh, yes, we can. To the lecherous Gerhard. Well, I don't know about lecherous, just because I have lots and lots of different venereal diseases. I don't think we need to go that far.
So we do have... They do have some of our people.
No. We are saying, you, give me your son.
Oh, wow. Okay. Well, we probably don't need to do that. I mean, we can. There's no harm, no foul. Well, I guess some will be fine either way.
Yeah, no.
I thought that this was demanding the return of a captured.
No. Okay, right? And this prestige is working out pretty great.
Yeah, we're net like 40 down from before the war.
Yeah, and we now run Arborea. He fucking hates us. That's okay. Is the peasant war done? Yep, everybody disbands now. Everybody can rest. And then I want to sort out my new marshal. Because Benedicta, no. Absolutely not.
Wait, a rational zealot, that is no temperament for a marshal.
No. Instead, I would like to hire Cunegund, a brave, wrathful, gregarious, brilliant strategist, an unyielding defender, a peasant leader, and a giant.
And extremely young.
Whoa.
Wow.
She's great.
And a known criminal.
Okay, she does not like us.
No, not yet.
No, so we should start trying to sway her.
I agree.
95% chance of success. The master of the hunt, Agnes, enters my chamber brimming with excitement. I am hearing tell of strange things from the gamekeepers of Locudoro. That is where Mariano is. That's the guy who hates us. Here. They tell glimpses of a bear with snowy white fur. It is said to roam the highlands, though none have gotten close to it. There are indeed legends of such beasts. White, you say? No immediate effects. County of Locudoro gained legendary sighting. So we could do a legendary hunt there. That's great.
If we can afford a hunt, it might help with our stress problem. Which I forgot that we had.
Let's see. You can now create the Duchy of Sardinia. Don't have enough gold, but that's okay. Powerful vassals expect council positions. Oh, Torbenu wants a council position now. No. But.
Ooh, too much.
But we'd gain prestige.
I have an idea.
Oh, yeah.
We should ask for gold from the Pope.
Because he fucking loves us.
Because he loves us now.
Okay, all right.
Look, Pope, we got to form this duchy.
Okay, now how do I do this? I go to the Pope here in the papacy.
Yep. You remember where Rome is now.
I do remember where Rome is. He has two hats. Three. And I say, ask for gold. He will not accept because of how I am a sinner.
Ooh, but it's so close. Now this is who we should sway.
Right, rather than the giant who now runs our army.
Right. She's already accepted the position.
Yeah, she's already accepted the position. It's time to sway the Pope.
It's time to get the Pope on board. 20%. Yikes.
20% chance. Yikes.
But we'll get some opportunities in there.
Well, we could play chess with him.
Ooh, but we could get a lot of stress. We will get a lot of stress. Maybe we will wager fortune. How's his intelligence and his martial? Oh, his skills don't seem that good. Yeah, I think we could beat this guy in chess. We could wager fortune, and it wouldn't give us the stress. I guess we have some personality trait that would make us hate to play a friendly game.
Yeah, it's because we're arrogant, I think.
Yeah.
Okay.
150 prestige is pretty good too. I think both of those are good.
Yeah, okay.
Because the wager fortune is not a lot of
We just start by just swing.
Start by just swing.
No, because we want to go on a hunt, don't we? We want to catch that bear.
Yeah, but the bear won't get us anything but prestige.
But
we can get prestige by wagering the fame.
Oh. Huh.
And the wagering just doesn't get us enough fortune.
No, I think you're right.
If it got us more fortune.
The Pope had better things to do.
It didn't say that was a possibility.
No.
Did we just go critical?
Yeah.
We've got to lose that.
Okay. We could go on a grand tour. No, we can't. It's too much money. Fuck.
Let's look at our decisions.
Okay. Okay. Well, none of these are great.
Yep, one of them.
Which one?
Visit a brothel.
Oh. We lose 15 gold. We lose some stress. Yeah.
Here I come, girls.
Lovely. Excellent. But we do it again because we're wanton. But also, what risks, you know?
Yeah, risk schmisk.
Risk schmisks. I can't get sicker.
No. Yeah, what are we going to get? A lover's pox?
Yeah, it doesn't work like that. It's not like the Pope's hats. We could exchange hostages with Duke Falco. No, I want the Pope to like me more.
Basil, a plant, says... visit a brothel will become unavailable for 3 years is wild. Like, what did you do? Yeah, it is. It's always funny. Like the decisions always that like help you always come with things like that. Like when you like exercise, you can take a walk, but only once a year.
Watch out. The walk getter will come and get you. Hey, we have a bigger army than the Pope.
We don't actually. More allies than the Pope has.
That's true. And it's very unlikely that people would join us in a war against the Pope.
This is a unique time in the game where the Pope is not actually that strong. But the Pope will become extremely strong.
So is this when we get him, Keith?
This is when we, I think, get the areas around the Pope.
Oh, do you want to go to a grand tournament?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, that yes. is a way to make some money.
Absolutely. Here we go. Now,
do we have a champion?
We or have Terran the Plains. Ooh, you mean our champion could be this giant lady?
I think so.
Let's see. Who's our current champion?
I think no one.
Personal champion, no one. Can take your place in some duels. Earns you prestige when competing in a grand tournament. Oh my god, it's this lady.
Yeah, there we go. Her martial is extremely good. How is her prowess? That's important.
Let's see.
17, okay, also really good.
Yeah, also excellent. This lady's unbelievable.
Yeah, tremendous.
And she might like us more. A bit.
Yeah. Yeah, five more.
Okay. absolutely
aptitude,
we're gonna go
good. Like, what else could you possibly want out of a personal champion? Maybe
we
should have sorted by aptitude, but still.
No. We're going north to Kassan. This is going to be wonderful, Keith.
Yeah, this is great.
Our giant is going to kill them all.
This is exactly what we needed.
My fellow attendee, Duke Magnus, is hosting a grand tournament competition in the vicinity of Castle, and time has come for us to depart. We shall represent the House of Etichonan and make the Swabian people proud. Hopefully the rest of Castle won't be as rotten as Duke Magnus, but we should still be wary of what goes down when in the lion's den. He thinks we're fine. I don't know what we mean about rotten, but, you know, I suppose we must. Guys, I'm going to have a great time. My hostage, Waldo, has been impressed with one of the house. He just, you know, the thing about Waldo is that he does wear this. Oh, that's Schlestat. He wears a red and white striped thing, and he keeps getting into wacky scrapes in scenes where it becomes very difficult to see him. He's been impressed with one of the household knights for a very long time. He's been repeating the warrior's words. Yeah, I think it'd be good if he got patient, and I don't want to get stressed.
Yeah, I agree.
I want to know about our Marshall's motto. She's from House Scharfenberg, so we could be worthy of Christ's promises. Okay.
Cool. Fine. Normal.
Yeah. As we traverse the farmlands, trudging through the dirt, we encounter a modest wayward shrine. Naively carved, it sports a cross at its head, and below the weathered words, here lays Saint Heribert of West Franconia, blessed son of Frankfurt. St. Heribert of West Franconia? It seems a local spiritual figure is being patronized in these parts, not one sanctioned by the Catholic clergy. Cast down this heterodoxy. You gain 50. You gain desecrated tomb. Adelheid. I don't know who she is. Doesn't like us.
I think that's just the person who is in charge of the place where they have this heterodox tomb.
Oh, sure. This means that we all like each other a bit more, and I patronized a local saint. Or we could just leave.
We don't need the piety. I always donate to the little heterodox tombs in my playthroughs because I think it's fun to be like a kind of weird guy who likes sort of local Christian splinters. But we are so low on gold, and we really need that gold. So I think this might be a don't
cast
do
down
anything.
The oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Just ignore it.
Yeah. Sounds good to me. Our smoke alarm's
Ozzie
just
Damien's.
Gone off. I'm just going to check the cat is okay. I imagine
sure.
Something was burned, but I feel like if a smoke alarm goes off, I should just check.
Yeah. While Jack's gone, I should take this opportunity to say that our fourth episode of Media Club Plus came out today. That is the podcast that me and Jack and Sylvie and Dre do, where we watch and talk about Hunter x Hunter, the extremely good anime television program from 2011. We've been having a blast doing this show. We've recorded, I think, 11 episodes. Four of them are out. They come out every other Tuesday. It's a great show. You should check it out if you're a Friends of the Table fan or if you like us here on Twitch. You can find Media Club Plus in your podcast app of choice or go to mediaclub.plus. It was a really good episode today, and they will... The episodes we're covering are like we're on a hot streak that will not be over for a while. We're up to, as far as the released episodes go, we're up to episode 12 of the anime. Let's see, anything else? On a personal note, we just finished on Runbutton, youtube.com/Runbutton. We just finished the Digimon World Let's Play that me and Kyle have been doing for almost 11 years. In February, it'll be 11 years. 58 parts. It's a bizarre game. I like to describe it as an entire game's worth of the weird Pokemon rumors, like Mew is under a truck or Surfing Pikachu. Like, it's just a game where no one knows exactly how it works or how to do anything. And it's been a ton of fun, and it's a weird time capsule of our lives. It took a third of my life to finish that Let's Play, so it's a bizarre kind of enormous chunk, a meaningful chunk of human life. And you can find that at youtube.com/runbutton. We have our Digimon World shirt that our friend Courtney made over at runbutton.shop. You can find that. And there's other stuff there too, like Runbutton shirts and Fruit of Grape from our Shenmue Let's Play, and then some stickers, stuff like that. Thank you to Splody, who subscribed with Prime for 2 months. Appreciate it. We also hit our, I don't know when, hit our subscriber goal or our follower goal of 5,600. So I'll update that. If you haven't used your Prime sub this month, why don't you go ahead and throw that towards Friends of the Table? The split on Twitch is much worse than on Patreon for like paid subs, but Prime subs are Prime subs. So,
hello,
hi,
everything's okay. Kat says hello, Keith, and also I'm so sorry. That's what they said. They were just cooking something and the oven burned a bit. I went out and they were waving a dishcloth at the smoke alarm.
It's okay. Tell them I said hi and that I used the time to plug Media Club Plus and Run Button. So.
I was listening to Media Club Plus today while I was doing dishes. It's a good podcast.
It's a really good podcast. Yes. I think that we have been doing a really good job. You know, I've been doing Run Button since 2011. I've been doing podcasts in general since, it'll be my 15th anniversary of doing podcasts. Whoa. In next month. I started in November of 2008 doing podcasts. But Run Button is such a casual, and I think we try to cultivate a vibe of like non-professionalism. Yeah. And Friends of the Table is such a more professional venture that I was nervous about hosting a show that like needed to be well hosted. Thank you. I've stopped being nervous about it.
Yeah.
Because I think it's been going pretty well.
As a little hint, I'm currently in the process of learning about Nen, something called Nen. If that doesn't mean anything to you, don't worry. You'll get there and you'll hear a lot of it.
Yes, you will hear a lot of it. Yeah. Empress says, thank you for the reminder on the non-automatic renewal of Prime. Yes, Prime subs do not automatically renew. So if you have subscribed to us with Prime in the past, that's over. And if you wanted to give it to us again, you got to do it all over. I don't even know how you do it. I did it once, months and months ago, just to experiment. I've since forgotten.
I have arrived at the site of the tournament here in Castle. Though not all the revelers have yet arrived, throngs of people wander through the colorful surroundings, all looking forward to the forthcoming displays of skill and prowess. There is no time to lose. I must begin preparing. I must be a victor at absolutely any cost. Okay. So,
Jack, just a quick note to not look at the chat, just in case, because Nen talk. So.
I'm going to make chat disappear for 5 minutes. God, imagine if I said, I'm going to make chat disappear for 5 minutes and then timed everybody out. Instead of just closed it on my screen.
Yeah. And it wouldn't help because then no one would be there to talk, to move everything down.
Yeah. Yeah. It wouldn't help at all. Okay. Our goal at this tournament is.
I think it should be recreation. But
that will
Triumph
reduce
is
our
not
stress.
A, yeah, that. Oh, you know what? We just reduced our stress a bunch. Forget about it. Let's win this.
Yeah. Now, the only person I'm interested in befriending or seducing right now is the Pope.
Right.
Is there
Either
anybody
or.
Here who we could kill?
There's plenty of people we could kill. But I think right now we need money and prestige, and that comes with Triumph.
Now, we could kill the King of France.
Sure. I don't know what that would do for us, but we could. our attentions have been solidly south and east.
Yes, you're right. Yeah, I think Triumph is a good plan. This tournament is going to be in three phases. Wait, it really is just a board game and a horse race? That's it?
the person who sets up the tournament decides what the events are. And I've only ever been to one where it's a fully martial tournament, which is very, very funny.
So it's a board game and a horse race, and then the ceremony? And we brought the strongest, toughest lady on the planet?
Yeah.
Okay, right. So let's see. What do we want to do?
I think that we should go to the tourney grounds,
and
guess is a game store.
Go, chicken, go faster. I hear a woman's voice echo across the grounds. I look up to see a small thing hurrying through the sky like a little black bolt of lightning. Soon enough, it swoops down across the finish line. Bah, you must have cheated. Your bird cannot fly that fast. Just look at her. She's as thick as you, the angry loser shouts, with the winner looking smug. Dorothea versus Clara von Altena. Now, we could learn something from here. We could gain 5 trait experience in Falconer, but gain 22 stress because we're arrogant. We could lose the stress because we're patient. We could just increase our score, you know, in the games.
That. Yeah.
We could make them... We could bet that it would do it again, but it's very likely we would lose that bet. Although that's a big prestige gain. You see that?
It is. Yeah, yeah. It's not a bad gamble. I think it's got to be either preparation or double or nothing, leaning towards preparation.
Yeah.
Because we will end up ensuring more prestige if we actually win.
Yeah. Our horse contest aptitude is currently terrible.
Huh. But what of our champion?
But what of our champion? I think we might have brought the wrong lady.
Yeah, maybe. The other thing is that we're going to be getting a lot of prompts, basically dice rolls and opportunities to increase our win chances. And so right now it might be terrible. Worst case scenario, we end up gaining some horse ability, which isn't the worst thing in the world.
And our wit for the board game isn't too bad. Oh my god, the prize will be revealed at the end of the contest. This is so cute. Okay, we're going to play a series of board games. Here are the participants.
This, to me, this screams not a very good prize because it is not a very expensive tournament, which all the tournaments I threw had 5 events.
Oh, damn. Wow. Yeah. However, this will likely give an illustrious artifact due to fine prizes. I think this tournament might have a fine prizes.
Okay. Those are separate. You can have a good prize for a shitty tournament or a shitty prize for a good tournament.
I always had the best.
Yeah. It's just worth the money to save a little bit of money to throw a better tournament, I think.
This prestige gains already. Just we qualified, so we gained 75 prestige. This is going to be really useful for getting
These events are whatever the events are geared towards, the pilgrimage, the hunts, the tournaments, they are like machines for giving you the stat they're meant to give you.
The contestants take their places at the gaming tables, fluffing their cushions and requesting refreshments as the herald announces the contest's commencement. The games themselves are arrayed out on trestle tables, pieces polished to a mirror sheen. The board game qualifiers have come to an end, and it's clear who will be put forward for the quarterfinals as it stands. The varied pitches and volumes of the crowd's cheers leave no question as to the favorites. For my first bout, I have been paired against my fellow contestant, Kaus Ausbjorn of Lolland Falster. Let's see, what's this guy's deal? He is a good marshal. He has poor intrigue, average learning, poor prowess. He killed a member of his extended family. He killed Princess Ragnhild Svenstatter of Denmark. Okay. That's going to be the opening salvo. That's the icebreaker. I sit down opposite him and say, did you kill Princess, let me see, Ragnhild Svensdatter of Denmark?
Damn.
What's this guy's memories? He was defeated at the Battle of Wilsia.
We can read someone's memories?
Yeah. Yeah. Did you not know about this? It's great. It's on the...
No.
Oh
my God.
Here. Yeah, for
example. See the memories of this character. Wow, I didn't realize that we were supernatural.
Yeah, it's great. It's really, really cool. Also, it's we can see the whole world at once.
Can we see our own memories?
Yeah, I think so. Let's see.
It's funny that my character would have a different memories than I do of them. Hey, look at that. I traveled to Cologne for my very first pilgrimage.
That's where we saw God in the cave.
Yeah, that's where we saw God in the cage. Some people would call him Darth Vader, but...
God in the cave is Darth
Vader? Yeah, that's who I saw in the cave.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Is this a Star Wars thing that I don't understand?
Yeah, it's fine now.
Okay. Time to play a board game. Now, do we want to place a gold wager?
No.
No.
I think you can get in trouble for betting on yourself or on the other person. Be like, you know, Pete Rose style.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I vowed to myself I would win a contest in this tournament, and I can't help but consider a less fair approach to securing the prize. I'm sure my opponents would do the same if they only had the idea. Okay. And there's a, you know, it's very likely here that nothing happens.
Yeah. Hey, do you want to hit the drop down on the right hand side of the screen? Ekbert is the favored contestant. So let's see if we even have a good chance of.
Of taking out Ekbert. Okay. There's a 39% chance it's successful. There's a 20% chance it's detected. And a 37% chance just nothing happens. So
those are not terrible odds, but I guess it's up to you. I would say either that or do it fair.
Why? It's Crusader Kings.
That's why.
Nothing happened. We weren't seen. Just nothing happened.
Okay, that's fine. That's fine.
Fiddlesticks. That's a thing they said in medieval times.
I was hedging against not wanting to lose that 75 prestige.
Yes.
The silence is deafening. Count Asbjorn has been contemplating his next move for what seems like an aeon. Eyes gazing intently at the chessboard beneath knitted brows. Clearly, the man wants to win. Once the idea of distracting him pops into my head, it's hard to dispel.
Okay, now, we can't do cheap tricks because we just gain stress. Although we could probably take that stress because we went to the brothel so spectacularly.
But there's no... Yeah, we really went to the brothel. We went to 3 years of brothel in one go.
It's fairly likely here that we get a coughing fit for 5 months. Oh my God. Yeah, was it... I think we were doing a Crusader Kings stream, right, Keith? Where we saw that one of the characters had a headache that was going to last for 2 years.
Yeah, yes. Okay, so there's a 50% chance that coughing will decrease their score moderately. And only a 5% chance of backfire.
And we don't spend this prestige. We should just do this.
Yeah,
although
I think
we will gain coughing fit, which gives us a minor health penalty, but I'm not too worried about that.
Yeah, 5 months, who cares?
Asbjorn takes no mind?
Doesn't care. Yeah, there was a 44% chance of just nothing happening.
Yeah. Okay, we are deep in the endgame now. How this game ends is anyone's guess. Maybe I draw from my knowledge of warfare, combined learning and martial challenge. You seem awfully sure of yourself, combined learning and diplomacy challenge.
That's better.
Perhaps it's time for a daring move. Nope. Playing it safe is the right move. Ooh, dear.
So it seems like warfare is the best one. Oh, sorry, sure of yourself.
Yeah. Yeah. Nice.
Was that a win?
Yeah, I think so. Oh, it's the Lewis Chessman. I can't help but allow my visage to crack a moment and smile as my opponent falls perfectly into the trap I had laid. A few moves later, and I have pressed the opening to an advantage. Moments later, I realize at last the danger of my position. Asbjorn had been baiting me from the start. He had been baiting me into a trap for half the game, biding his time while I blundered. By now, there is no escape. The judges call an end. I have lost.
Damn.
He knocked us out. Oh, wow. My God. I thought I was doing great. Progress to victory was...
Yeah, it was really high. I think it was just that last thing that we didn't win, that that coughing fit.
That fucked us up.
Yeah.
Hunman has learned Hebrew. Okay.
Hey, that's great.
Okay, Guital is through to the final. Jean is through to the final. Jean and Guital are in the final. Why couldn't it just be killing or something? We brought the strongest lady in the world.
The strongest lady in the whole world.
Guital wins the board game contest. Fucking fine. Okay.
That's fine. Yeah, whatever. Now it's time to get really good at horse riding very quickly.
Very, very quickly. We're currently not qualifying for the horse racing. We will likely
we have time
qualify?
To qualify. We have time to qualify. That's what the next few things will be about.
My champion didn't even qualify. Oh, no. Okay. Okay.
Yeah, tourney grounds, definitely.
Okay. They're fighting drunkenly. But I'm here. Interesting. Do you have thoughts here, Keith?
I think gaining the prestige, that's a lot of prestige.
Yeah, just by being like, you guys suck.
Yeah.
I'm not going to be in a fight.
Yeah. Unfortunately, it was not an opportunity to gain qualifying points, but we still have time, I think. I think that we can have a... every 2 weeks, I think that we have a...
Yeah,
it's
about to happen.
Yeah. If you pause, it'll tell us which the ones that we can do, which gives us chance. Yeah, there we go. Progress to victory.
Yeah, we can't go there for another...
We can't go there for another 2 weeks.
10 days.
Or 10 days or something, yeah.
We could pray for victory. We could enter the village.
No... Maybe artisan quarters?
Get new clothes, improve your weaponry.
No.
Not looking good.
Yeah. We've got time. We still can make it to the tourney grounds. Why don't we just wait 10 days?
Okay.
We still should be able to go twice.
Okay. So, we could hire Guichard, Count Leonard's counselor, who looks fucking sick as hell. He's an evil blackguard.
Yeah.
But I want... it's got to be this. Your score increases
slightly.
Yeah,
it's got to be that.
Yeah. Oh!
There we go. Currently guaranteed to qualify.
Now, do we know
Beautiful.
Shit about horses?
I know everything there is to know about horses.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yep.
You cannot visit this locale for 27 days, so we won't be able to visit the tourney grounds again.
No. Artisan quarters, maybe. It'll give us a chance to... It's possible that we'll have a free, score increase there.
Yeah.
But it's also possible that they'll try to sell us something, so...
Right. Erroneous escutcheon. Browsing the wares on display, I spy a carefully wrapped package among the piles of garments. The tailor opens it for me, carefully untying the leather bindings to reveal an exquisitely embroidered crest, the Zaringen crest. This is Herman's. Duke Herman of Carinthia.
Not to be confused with Herman.
Not to be confused. Whoa, 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 whoa. Look at this beard.
Wow.
Amazing. Do me a favor, burn this. He gains stress and loses opinion of us. Listen, I'll take these, but no word of it. And we possess the crest of another house, giving us wow. great opportunity to mislead. Lovely, I want the Etichonan crest. We get it, but then
get nothing for it.
Yeah.
Well, I guess we get a little bit of renown, and renown's important. I guess.
Very nice work. Okay, what do we think?
I guess burn it. I don't want to spend 15 gold on it, and I don't really think that we're gonna be encountering that guy anytime soon.
Oh, God. The finest horses in Angria, adorned in the colors of their owners, are led around the track as the herald announces the contest's commencement. The riders mill around as they wait for the beasts to arrive, some stretching, some eyeing each other up. My fastest horse, Snow, has not gone unnoticed by the breeders and gamblers.
Snow.
No betting.
Yeah.
Unless... because we're not going to win this. We could put a bet on
We could win this.
But what if we bet on Count Asbjorn of Lollan Falster? His name is literally Faster.
I think it's up to you, but I think that that we came here to win, and we should try to win.
Okay. My horse is all set, of course, but the beast is nothing without a capable rider to control it. As a result, I find myself with three potential riders, arrayed before me, all clamoring for the honor of being allowed to represent me. None of the three seem like particularly outstanding candidates. All of them are complete strangers to me, and clearly just commoners looking for a shot at fame and fortune, but they are the only ones available. We can choose Mechtild, Siegmund, or Ekkehard.
Well, let's take a look at their things here.
Okay, Ekkehard is mostly a spymaster. He's lazy, arbitrary, and cynical. He's a skilled tactician and a rough terrain expert.
Okay, rough terrain expert, that's something.
Mechtild is lustful, diligent, content, an indulgent wastrel, and slow.
No.
Nope. Siegmund is arrogant, calm, zealous, a brilliant strategist, and an open terrain expert.
That's good enough for me.
Pretty good stats. Yep, Siegmund. Siegmund, you'll do. This is a 26-day horse race.
Yep.
Very complex.
Long. Very long.
The horses thunder along the track, their coursing bodies obscured by clouds of dust, the cursing and yelling of their jockeys inaudible amidst hoofbeats and the roar of the crowd. Still, you can tell your rider Siegmund is utterly focused on a rapidly approaching turn. As the others slow to take the sharp bend in stride, your rider spurs hard. With just a finger's breadth to spare, Siegmund and Snow slip between those ahead. An incredible maneuver. The crowd gasps as one. Such skills belong on the battlefield. You lose the money, but you gain daring cavalrymen. So our cavalry get better. That's interesting. My entourage could use a new scout. You lose the money, gain daring scout, which boosts our travel speed, but we gain 44 stress, or a moment worth 1,000 tellings, and we gain the prestige and lose 14 stress. This is absolutely the one we should do, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, we've unlocked Constant Care. Our dynasty is upgraded. Boleslaw's rider is tearing their way along the track. At the last moment, they sloppily careen to the side, skating through the dirt, giving the riders of Guitol and Adolf's horses no time to stop. The crowd's unanimous groan fills the air even before the three horses and riders collide.
Ouch.
Ouch, or Boleslaw, how could you let that happen?
So we could taunt them or not taunt them.
I'm not going to taunt them. I don't need to.
This is the thing. I never even know enough of who these fucking people are to know if I would benefit from taunting them.
No. Okay. Right. The race continues. Whoa. Look at this. It's a 3D horse. I've never seen that before.
I saw in real life. I've seen it, but yeah.
You've seen a 3D horse in real life?
Yeah.
All the horses I've seen are 2D. I was born with a horrible condition where horses and other animals appear as weird cartoon artifacts. Yes.
It's funny because I'm on 15 frames a second mode. And so it just looks terrible. This is like I'm on like Windows 98 sort of
amazing
pre-rendered cutscene horse.
The horses continued to thunder around the course, the remaining riders sawing at their steeds' reins to urge them ever faster. It has been an eventful race already, I think, remembering when a multiple-horse pileup took out three riders in one fell swoop. That did happen. There is only one more lap to go. I lean over the edge of the stand and shout down at my rider as the pack passes. Extra pay if you win. There's a 44% chance your score decreases greatly and a 33% chance it increases. Hit them in the face.
No.
Doesn't go well for us. Grab their reins.
Oh. That's a little better. That is slightly the best option.
Yeah, it could either go just as badly as it could go just as well. Or go faster. 62% chance nothing happens.
I guess it would have to be grab their reins. That's the... It's just a better version of go faster.
Oh, no! Unbalanced and surprised by my call, my rider wobbles and almost falls. My horse loses a little ground as they round the final bend into the home straight.
Ooh.
This is going to be close. My horse is bolting free of the chasing pack. If it can hold off my rivals, we'll win. The crowd reaches a crescendo. The riders urge their steeds on in unison. The finish line looms. Has happened. Your score decreases greatly.
Unfortunate.
Wow, that horse is huge.
Yep. This is what happens if you lose. Is you get trampled by a 400-foot-tall horse.
Good God. Count Asbjorn's horse, Storm, crosses the line as the crowd erupts, closely followed by your Snow and King Boleslav's the Second's Wind. Snow didn't even place. I will have to be better prepared next time. So close. But we got prestige, and we got money, and we got the skill horse racer. You know?
Yes. Yeah. Huge.
Yeah, we, this is exactly what we sort of wanted.
Yeah, we like quadrupled our prestige, so. Maybe more than quadrupled it.
Yeah. The sun comes down on the final day of the tournament, and the massed crowds begin to disperse. I find myself ruminating over the results. Count Asbjorn's horse finished first in the horse racing. Count Guitel's sharp mind outthought all adversaries to win the board games. I was unable to win a contest. I look forward to the next one. What a great occasion.
And what a positive duke we are.
We are a real optimistic guy.
Yeah, a real gracious loser.
Yeah. Everybody does okay. We do okay. All right, war.
All right, back to war. Back to doing a war.
Oh, we didn't sway the Pope. Shit. Oh, now, hold on. Franconian women. This again, huh?
We should leave this woman alone.
Yeah, can we beat the stress?
Jesus Christ, 44. But I'm imploring you, if you're playing Crusader Kings, not that you could avoid it, don't be lustful and rakish.
It's not good.
It's a bad combo.
Okay.
I think that we should eat the 44. We're really low right now.
Yeah. Yep. Fair enough. Okay. Oh my god. The fields of Marburg are a sight to behold. Every crop in bloom, every leaf green, every stem luscious. I quickly track down the source of the verdancy, spotting a man standing in a field, seemingly holding a lecture of some sort to a gathering of listeners. Can I get a woods pervert here, please?
Hello.
Fuck. Here. How do you do the woods pervert voice?
Oh, it's been too long.
My name is Master Gottschalk.
He notices me in the distance and turns in my direction.
My knowledge of gardening is vast, yes, incomparably vast. So stay a while and listen.
Okay, I mean, come on. Fuck, no.
Okay,
shit.
Down to earth for 10 years. What does that do? Okay.
No.
50% chance we gain gardener.
Ooh.
Minus 20% stress gain. That's huge.
Because it will overwhelm us. Will it overwhelm us?
It will not overwhelm us.
We will lose a lot of prestige, but we're about to do a bunch of wars and get
how
that
much,
prestige.
Sorry, how much prestige is it losing to become a king?
150.
Wow. Wow, wow, wow. You know, it might... Maybe it's not worth it for this.
Look at this guy with his arms.
Yeah.
Like he's holding an invisible
garden,
second grade.
You could stand like me and not even care.
At first, they thought it was silly, but then I thought of the tulips and the daffodils.
When you love the earth, you learn to love the flowers, too.
That sounded like there was a kind of cadence to that, like I just clicked on you in an RTS game.
Halfway through, I started reminding myself of Mr. Burns when he's... when they think he's an alien in
Were
Simpsons.
You a big Simpsons person? This is
No, not at all, actually.
We haven't really talked about The Simpsons. Ever, I don't think. And we've known each other for a decade.
Yeah. I didn't watch The Simpsons at all until a couple years ago. I watched seasons 3 through 10 of The Simpsons.
Did you have a good time?
Yeah, I thought especially seasons like 3 through 7 or 8, I thought it was really, really good. I thought it was like... kind of startlingly good. And then kind of quickly begins a steady descent into season 10. I could start to see like, oh, here's where like it starts turning into modern Simpsons. They don't really have the juice anymore.
That's so interesting. I have heard, and I don't know if this is true, I have heard that contemporary Simpsons, like right now Simpsons, is not as bad as you might think it would be. And I realize that on some level that's damning with faint praise. You know, not as bad as you might think it would be is not the most glowing endorsement of a television show. But I saw some writing that was like, maybe you should see what the show is doing now, which is interesting. I don't think I will, but you know.
Yeah, I'm... The problem is that I have the kind of brain where I would want to watch everything in between
and then you've got 30 seasons of
I don't want to watch 20 more seasons of The Simpsons when I was kind of already bowing out around season 10.
Were you a big cartoons person as a kid?
Yes, I watched a lot of cartoons as a kid.
What was your favorite cartoon?
Well, I guess different eras of being a kid, but I really loved Pokemon like when I was a young kid. And then as I got older and I was like a teenager, let's see, what was I watching like when I was like 14, 15? I guess I don't really have, maybe I wasn't watching a lot of, I was watching anime then. I was watching like Dragon Ball Z and Naruto and stuff like that. And then when I was younger, I was watching like Pokemon and SpongeBob. I guess Pokemon also an anime. So I was watching anime the whole time. I was watching Yu Yu Hakusho. I was watching Dragon Ball and Dragon Ball Z. I was watching Naruto. I was watching...
Oh, so you watched Togashi Show as a kid?
Yes. Yu Yu Hakusho has been one of my favorite shows since I was like 12.
That's fascinating because I'm really envious of... So Kat watched Sailor Moon as a kid. You know, would come home from school and watch Sailor Moon. And then Yu Yu Hakusho followed Sailor Moon. So Kat knows the beginning of Yu Yu Hakusho episodes and that's it.
That's really funny.
Which is great. And I'm really envious of that kind of particular TV experience in much the same way that I think to myself, oh, it would have been so much fun to be in the theater in 1970, whatever, and watch Halloween, you know, for the first time. Yeah. Nobody knows what a slasher is. I'm sure I've told you this story. My parents saw Halloween in theaters before knowing what a slasher movie was, and it scared the shit out of them. My parents talk about Halloween as like one of the most frightening theater experiences they've had, which is
and
really
it's so
cool.
Funny because watching it now, it's nothing. I mean, it's really great, but it's not scary.
It's not scary. I mean, it's scary in a couple of moments. There are a few moments where it still does it, but
I can feel that it's being scary, which is actually what I prefer. I don't actually want to be scared. I just want to get the flavor of it.
Yeah, yeah. But
I'm a baby.
You know, I think about... Have you seen The Thing, right?
Yes, I've seen The Thing, yeah.
Yeah, I love The Thing so much.
Yeah, me too.
And The Thing, to me, is... Oh, I don't know. Is The Thing scary to me? Yeah. What they put on the screen in that movie is enough to too frightening.
Like Halloween, the thing is suggesting a scary idea. In Halloween, it's being followed and not knowing you're being followed, which is the same fear that I have of the ocean, my one real life fear, which is like not knowing what's beneath the surface, not being able to see. It's not that I'm afraid of sharks. I'm afraid of that there could be a shark and I wouldn't know. Like the fear of being grabbed at any moment. And the thing is the same thing, which is like, it's the fear that the people around you aren't who they say they are.
And you're isolated and that's going to be it.
Yeah.
We should watch Prince of Darkness, which is another John Carpenter picture about university students who accidentally discover Satan in the basement of an abandoned church.
Yeah, you mentioned this one a couple times to me.
Yeah,
I definitely would watch that.
It's not, I don't know, it's not great, but it is great, if you know what I mean.
You know what you need to do? You need to watch Big Trouble in Little China.
Oh, I've already seen it, but I saw it as a kid. I saw it as a kid and had a good time. But I think I don't think I was on its frequency in the way that I needed to be.
Yeah.
That's a movie that I want to go back to. I really want to watch Halloween 3 again this year. Halloween 3 is one of my favorite Halloween movies. It's called Season of the Witch. It doesn't have Michael Myers in it at all.
You recommended this to me last year, and I planned on watching it and just ran out of time. And since then, we watched Halloween 1, which I had also not seen, and I thought it was really great.
Halloween 3 has a spooky television commercial in it that causes bad things to happen to you. And the commercial is being counted, or rather, it's a TV broadcast, and the TV broadcast is being counted down to with a commercial that goes, 5 more days till Halloween, 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 5 more days till Halloween, Silver Shamrock. And I have had the Silver Shamrock television advert stuck in my head for days, which I think is the cue for me to watch that movie.
There's something about the horror idea. Apparently they do it in Halloween 3. There's a couple X-Files episodes about this, which I love. The X-Files, one of my favorite things of all time. Where, like, and I think it's specifically tied to the analog nature of old TV. It doesn't hit the same with digital, but there's something about like television being beamed to your TV, and the TV is shooting, you know, the cathode ray tubes like shooting electrons out at you.
Yeah.
And that is like doing something to you. That is like, it's sort of like a They Live style propaganda idea, or paranoia, not propaganda, paranoia thing of like I'm being physically changed by this media, like in a literal way, which is
totally
a great metaphor, and also is a terrifying idea that is just barely rooted enough in the physical world to feel terrifying.
Have you seen Videodrome?
No.
Have you seen much Cronenberg?
Really, no.
Okay, Cronenberg is kind of horrible to watch. He's brilliant. Just like one of the greatest to do it. And it turns out that his son, Brandon Cronenberg, is also extremely good at doing this.
My feeling is that I could watch a lot of Cronenberg stuff because it seems more gross than scary.
Yeah.
But there's a limit to that. Like, I really wanted to see his recent movie, Crimes of the Future, the one that has the same title as another movie that he made.
Yeah.
But it did just seem too gross.
It's
a lot
gross.
Of like really realistic effects of cutting into people's skin.
The Cronenberg movie that I can't watch is The Fly, which is about Jeff Goldblum turning into a fly. And it's just so visually upsetting. And I don't like Jeff Goldblum, so, you know, I'm not going to sit down and watch that. But Videodrome...
Really? You don't like Jeff Goldblum?
I have heard that he is not the greatest dude.
I guess I've also heard that, but I've never seen anything in particular, but I mean,
I have a particular sort of, I don't care for the like I'm a wacky, goofy guy.
Yeah, persona. I think he leans into that as a persona now in a way that wasn't true for a really long time.
I really like him in Jurassic Park. I think he's fantastic in Jurassic
Park.
Really
good in Jurassic Park.
And yeah. I really like him in The Life Aquatic, where he plays the wealthy sailor. But no, he is not a draw for me to a movie. But yeah, there's a Cronenberg movie called Videodrome, which is pretty much exactly the distilled horror of what you're describing. The idea that there is a broadcast that is capable of changing you. And of course, Cronenberg is in conversation with a bunch of stuff that's happening at the time, right? You know, the proliferation of VHS cassettes in VHS rentals, the idea that you're picking up a tape that you don't actually know what's on it.
I would be shocked if the X-Files episodes that I'm thinking of are like not specifically drawing from this kind of thing. That this is like the weird thing about horror, which is like I've seen almost no actual horror, but I have seen the X-Files episodes that are homaging and pastiching every fucking horror concept under the sun for 100 fucking episodes. It's like this weird sort of detached relationship with a lot of that kind of thing.
Yeah.
Like the network TV version of those movies I can stomach just fine.
Well, it's like, you know, the first time I heard about The Shining was in The Simpsons.
Sure, yeah.
And possibly Texas Chainsaw Massacre?
That's right. I've actually never read or seen The Shining, but I was like a big Stephen King reader from very young, like 11.
Why do you think
10,
you
11.
Skipped The Shining?
I don't know. I really don't know. Because I was in and around that. I read Carrie. I read Salem's Lot. Those are like literally sandwiching The Shining.
Totally.
and I read a bunch of that early stuff. And I read all of The Dark Tower. I read like The Dark Half. And then I read some of the more contemporary stuff, early 2000s stuff. I don't know. I don't know why.
I think you would really like The Shining. The Shining is great.
Yeah. I know everything that happens in it. But I haven't read it. I know all of the plot of it. Which is fine. I would enjoy a book even knowing the beginning, the middle, the end, and a lot of the details, but
yeah. Should we get back?
Oh, sorry. When
to...
you say enjoy The Shining, do you mean the book or the movie or both?
I think you would enjoy both. The I haven't seen the movie, but I have wanted to for a long time, and it's something that I really want to watch this Halloween. I think that'd be really fun. But I love the book. I think The Shining is an excellent book.
Yeah. Did you all like this podcast that we did in the middle of the...
We do one of these basically every episode.
Yeah, we
right?
usually put it at the beginning. This time we thought we'd mix it up. Put it 2 hours in.
Listen, fuckers.
this is just we're talking about it before, but I feel like this is the run button flavor.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
Someone else might have said like, and let's get back to the game an hour ago, but
no, of course not. No, Library Cats in the chat says, we know why we're here.
Yeah.
Okay, so here's the thing. Do we think we can afford this stress game?
We can.
I think we should also spend this prestige because we're going to get the prestige back in the war.
Yeah.
And there's a 50% chance we gain this trait Gardener, which would lower 20% stress loss for this ruler's life.
Yeah, which is will by far pay for itself.
Yeah.
And stress has been a big problem, so.
Yeah, I'm curious. Oh, yeah, hell yeah. Oh, that's
nice.
Brilliant. Okay.
That's great.
Yeah, that's fantastic. All right, now war, right? Now killing.
Now war and killing. Yeah, now that we gain less stress, let's go war and kill.
Yep, sounds good. And we want the Ducal Conquest here. Ah, now.
Ooh, that's still too much.
This is why we're going to form the place.
Oh, first, right. We form it first.
Yep. What is this under?
There is a wrinkle. I'm remembering a wrinkle. What we actually need to do in order to directly control the county is fabricate a claim and declare that war. so that we become the direct count of the
But can't we do this with Ducal Conquest?
No, I think Ducal Conquest will just force them to be our vassal, which we don't want.
It allows the seizure of counties required to create an uncreated title of the duchy rank. Yeah. Okay. Okay, that's fine. I'm okay with this. We just
it's a small wrench, but it's, I think that it'll be important in the long run.
And we can afford it.
Yeah. I have got I've been delivered by Isaac a Rhode Island special.
Oh yeah.
Mm-hmm.
What's the Rhode Island special?
A big stuffed quahog.
What is a quahog?
It's a kind of it's a big kind of clam.
Whoa. It's fish?
It is, yeah. So you take out all the clam meat and then you toss it with vegetables and spices and a dough, and then you put it, you fry it up, and then you put it back in there.
This sounds fantastic.
It is really, really good. Yeah. It's a local, one of those like famous local burger places that's been around forever and still sells really cheap burgers and has like a very old, loyal clientele that just like has way too good of food for what you'd expect. Also happens to have phenomenal stuffies.
Stuffies.
Yeah.
A fine day like this, the weather is nice, the pastures of Wetzlar look great, and the local livestock are positively jumping and cheering in their own guttural manner. Overall, the place is very competently run, though I notice a couple of oddities that I would manage a bit differently. Now, we are always going to gain stress here. Oh, no, there's a chance we're always going to gain stress here. There's a chance County of Strasbourg gains improved pastures. That would be great. We could improve things there, or we just gain... We should try and apply this back home. There's a really good chance this works out, and we get more money from it. Let's see. We currently have 3.4. If this works out... Ah, fuck. Okay, so don't worry about it. Oh, no! Okay.
Huh.
I need something to rebalance my humors. You gain the trait drunkard. I am surrounded by fools. You gain the trait irritable.
I don't think we should do either of those.
We should just gain the stress again and hope for a brothel.
Yeah, it said, sorry, what did it say? It said if we don't fix our stress within how long do we have to fix it?
No, it basically said if you go over again, it could be real bad for you.
Oh, but it also says if we don't lower it below this first level in X amount of time,
oh,
there's a penalty.
Well,
I don't remember
that.
How long.
Let's see. An imposing man is standing on the road ahead of us. I am Jakob of Klingenberg. He wants to fight us. We have no interest in you or a fair fight. Your whole entourage tramples Jakob. Your travel plan will be resumed. You may be less valuable after I win. There's an 8% chance we win and a 92% chance we spend 150 prestige, but we will lose stress. Or Kurrigund fights and she'll probably win.
Yeah, I think probably. Well, yeah, what is the one that loses us stress? Because I think we just have to do that.
Well,
oh, no. Yeah, sorry, I misunderstood.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, I think that's it.
Kanagan wins the fight.
Good. Predictable.
Yeah, very, very predictable. I've noticed that Kanagan avoids me more than usual. She always sits at the opposite end of the table whenever we're invited to a feast and consistently refuses my company when camping. We might not have the best of relationships, but that attitude is starting to tire me, especially when I overhear her defaming me. Gerhard is a lecherous bedswerver. I'd be a way better duke than him. Now, our options here are
news.
We fight her and we just lose. We just lose. We banish her, or we spend 75 prestige and gain 36 stress. This sucks.
I think we've got to banish her.
But she's our massive lady.
I know. She's our big giant girl.
No. Oh, no.
Maybe we can invite her back.
Maybe. Okay. Hang on. Oh, my God. And now our kid's gone missing. What the fuck? All right.
She stole our kid, I bet.
I bet she stole our kid. Okay, the mayor gets her council seat back. Mayor Benedicta. As we manage to walk through a dangerous path in worms, Keith!
Worms again?
Keith, the danger in worms.
It's once again, the danger in worms rears its ugly head or butt.
And you can't. We decide to rest for the night. As I walk around the encampment, suddenly a strange feeling that someone is missing bothers me. I ask around and everyone agree on one thing, that they don't remember seeing Gottfried all day. That is worrisome. She is still just a child. What if she got lost somewhere in the plains along the way? She's probably lonely and, more importantly, starving. Let's mount a search party for her. We lose the money. There's a chance that she comes back or she doesn't. I'll find them myself. And we get ill. There's a chance that we get ill. Oh my god. I don't want to risk more people getting lost. We gotta mount a search party.
Yeah.
Okay. Phew.
I'm confused how we get piety for allowing our child to stay missing.
Yeah, I don't really know how that works. Humming Bell in the chat says, ah, yes, the worst tarot combo. The big lady and worms. Okay, we can unlock a new perk. Ooh.
Sorry, was it worms or worms inverted? I can't tell. I can't believe I got to do that joke twice.
What's great is at first I thought you were just doing a tarot joke about how tarot cards are sometimes inverted. And then.
Yeah, it was two jokes in one.
And then I realized your little goof. Okay, accomplished forger we can't get yet, which sucks because this would increase our fabricate claim on county speed by 75%.
I know.
Instead, we have to unlock embassies.
Instead, we have to unlock embassies.
Instead, boo. Okay. Our marshal has left our court. She was in prison. She was that peasant. Okay. We've gotten home. We've gained two trade experience in horse.
We were away for 281 days.
I know. Damn.
Okay. By the way, we didn't check in on how our regency went at all. Did he steal any power or do anything
he
wrong?
He didn't do something great. He was like, by accident, he did a kind of a goof. That was the only thing I saw him do. It could have been way worse. You can create the Duchy of Sardinia. Oh, 200 gold.
We're close.
Yeah. Any chance the Pope
Hey, how's
likes
the Pope?
Us?
Yeah, that's exactly what I was thinking. You read my mind.
Any chance the...
No, the Pope thinks exactly the same about us.
No, he actually dislikes us more. Hey, what if we go on a hunt for that bear?
It would be pretty expensive. We definitely would get prestige, but we wouldn't get...
No, yeah.
Yeah, we need to save money for our claim.
For the claim. We're going to need to save money for the claim.
And then once we get the claim, we can just declare the war.
Yeah, and then we win really, really quickly.
The game.
Ah.
Yeah.
Someone's trying to kill Agnes, who I think is my mom? No, my mom is dead. She is just a lady. Avamai's getting on in years. He's 65. Okay.
Good old Avamai. Been with us the whole time.
He's our doctor, too, I think. The Hungarians are likely to win the Kingdom of Ruthenia. That's good. We want that because that makes more Hungary for when we invade Hungary.
Actually, we decided that it was going to be bad, actually, if they won that war.
Oh, we want them to lose that war?
We want them to lose that war. It's a thin line. It doesn't really matter. But if we win the title of King of Hungary, then the King of Hungary just becomes the king of whatever that other fucking place is. Where's the war with?
Ruthenia.
Ruthenia, yeah. He just retains that and then becomes our horrible, bitter neighbor.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
And then the other thing is, if he does get Ruthenia, then his troops will increase. He will get more troops. It'd be harder to kill.
Yeah, that's probably good to avoid. How's things going down here? Slow. What if our wife helps out with... this? Is that going to speed things up at all? 11 months left.
Oh, Hems and Haws and Comrade Furious in two parts, reminding me that our wife killed our mom.
Yes, she did. And then she died. And we weren't sad.
Yeah, we had a horrible, horrible wife.
Yeah, our wife wasn't. Okay.
To be fair, we did not treat her well.
No, it wasn't good to be our wife. Ooh, we're swaying the Pope. But it's not likely to go well.
Okay. Yeah, we are still swaying the Pope. We've still got a 20% chance, so let's, fingers crossed. I wish that we got, because sometimes they give you little events that's like, that helped increase your chances or even maybe gives you
five
for free.
He likes us.
Oh, awesome. Let's ask him for money. Quickly, before he realizes.
Quick. Yes.
Wow. There we go. We'll accept +6. Love that.
That's wonderful.
Oh,
you love
that's a load
to
off
it.
My shoulders.
The Pope gives us money. Pray St. Matthew, here comes the tax refund. Okay, that was 250 prestige, but we have piety. But we have so much piety. Okay. Now, how much will it cost us to hunt the boar? The bear. 120. Let's buy the thing first. But
yeah,
this will
we
also
really
help
should.
With our stress, is the other thing.
Yeah.
Okay, who is our current master of the hunt?
I think it's near the top.
Oh, it's Agnes. Okay, oh, yeah, she's great. Cool. We don't have a champion right now.
And that's probably fine.
Wait, did a boat just go zooming past? I just looked at the chat.
There was a boat.
Boat just absolutely blitzing past. Okay. This is going well. Now, something to consider is that they have these... Okay, they only have one ally, and it's with the Kaiser, but the Kaiser won't go to war with us. The problem is that we can't even prune allegiances here, right? Because his military strength is just huge from the start. We
right,
would need
yeah.
another allegiance to really power ourselves through this.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which is doable. And that's something we can really look to once we get this silver mine. Because we're already making really good money. How is county control in Colmar doing? This poor lady working really hard.
At least so we think.
At least so we think. Yeah. What does assist ruler help us with?
It gives a little bit to everything.
Oh, yeah. Right. I see why that is useful. Okay.
And I think that our wife happens to be pretty good in everything, which is what makes assist ruler a pretty decent pick.
Yeah. The Pope is giving us, could give us claims on a bunch of places. Augsburg here. Lombardy, which is here. Ooh.
Oh, that's not bad. That helps contribute to the long empire.
It really does. We sort of work our way down. And then Nitra from King Salomon.
Is that what we called it? Chat, if anyone remembers what we called it. The Long Empire, something like that.
He wants us to send our son as a hostage. That will not happen.
No, of course not. We would never do that to her.
No, and we've never done it to anybody else. Okay, that's...
What is
that's,
this?
That's
is
that a the... bit of Hungary. That's another bit of Hungary. Okay.
Hey, maybe bite off a piece. Oh, we still got to fight the whole guy, though.
Yeah, we would have to fight the entire guy.
He has
sadly
to fight the whole guy. Wouldn't even get the whole thing.
Yeah, we just get a little bit. It sucks. If we're going to go for it, you know? Might as well go for it. But every place we conquer gives us more levies.
Yeah. And this is about to trigger. Look at that.
Yeah. And once we get really good money, we can also start investing really hard in men-at-arms. Okay, 69. Nice.
See it done.
See it done. All right. Well,
off to war.
Well,
oh, they've gotten a bit stronger.
Oh, well, I think we're still good.
We still obliterate them. Yeah. We're gonna.
Oh, but that's including like the Kaiser, I think, or maybe our some
it's
ally we would
our
have
allies.
To pay.
Now, this is interesting. We only have a claim on Cagliari, so we would be forcing him into Tortoli.
Right. And then we can Dougal conquest. Because who cares about Tortoli?
Yes, we want the silver mine.
Yeah, we need that mine.
Oh, no!
Jeez.
Oh, no,
yeah,
we've given
did.
A Dale of the Lover's Pox. Oh, no. Shit. Okay.
We're horrible.
We're not great, are we? Okay. Yeah. Oops, didn't mean to do that.
Oh, no?
I raised the army in the wrong place.
Oh, okay. It's fine. You can dismiss them. Oh, excuse me. The game accounts for accidentally doing that.
Oh, that's helpful.
Yeah. And so if no time passes, basically they let you raise them.
Yeah. Okay. They're on
How
their
many
way.
Troops do we have raw? No, allies.
1,119.
Oh, so we really need.
Yeah.
We might want to hire a quick little mercenary band.
Just a few little mercenaries. Wait,
yeah, because
they're not hired by us. They are hired by someone else.
Right? Yeah. Just because.
Oh, it's money though. But
it's
we'll
a
make
lot
it back.
Of money. It's a lot of money. But we're gonna lose if we fight their 1,300 army right now.
Yeah. Okay.
Our other option is save the game. Call allies. And then just sort of avoid their armies until our allies show up. If
Let's
we want
to go. I would prefer not to. Company of the
yeah,
Hat.
Yeah, I agree.
So good. Captain Antario of the Company of the Hat. Look at this guy.
Not much of a hat.
No, really not much of a hat. Army of the Oar. Company of the Brabançon Wolf. Great company. Routiers of the Archpriest. I fucking love Dark Souls. Okay. Right. Make this safe. Okay, now we call our allies to war. It's here. Call to war. Spend 75 prestige. We can afford that. And this should cover us, at least for the time being. Because rain out of, well, ooh, we should have called Herman instead, but it would have cost more prestige.
Are you sure?
Yeah, this is 150 prestige. All right, let's see how it goes with this first guy.
How many does our first guy have?
Like 900?
Okay, well, that's fine. We only are barely losing to... Yeah. If we get to... Yeah, if we just like go to northern Galura, it should be high enough. Oh, but they're very quickly.
Yeah. Okay. Our councilors are fighting with each other, and we simply have to say a duke may pick his own council because.
Yeah.
We can't have this stress game.
And I, you know.
Oh shit!
Oh wow! What happened?
Fighting.
How did that happen? Okay, we should reload it. this is clearly an error of not having paused at the right time. The other obvious error was accidentally calling the wrong guys and also calling our troops to the wrong place.
Yeah.
How long were they up for? Because we They're already fully there, you know, like they're fully called.
Yeah, so let's disband our troops. And let's bring them in. God. The problem is Alsace is all the way up here.
Yeah, I don't think we should. I don't actually think that we should disband. We should like maybe bring them in a little bit further north. But I think that these guys are going to, unless we're right there, I think they're probably going to try to take over one of our cities.
Yeah, we bring them in here, maybe.
Yeah, but we should really call right away our ally, whichever one is closest is maybe the priority.
Oh, that's true. Let's see. Okay, Dole is there.
That's far.
That is far. Corinthia.
I can't tell where that is.
Is there?
Oh, that's not bad.
Okay, this is going to cost us 150 prestige, but we'll probably win the war.
Yeah.
And this guy has so many soldiers.
Yeah. Clean sweep.
Clean sweep. Right, now we hang out for a bit.
Yeah.
Why do I have 12 unread messages?
We should remember that it'll take a few months to gather our forces once we do decide to do that.
Yeah.
So now that they are captivated by sieging our city, we should call our troops in, I bet.
Yeah, up here in the north. Ooh. Okay, let's see. I'm just gonna impress the Kaiser. I'm sorry, we have business to attend to. Okay, this will be 5 months. Duke Caspar is raiding us? The Vikings are raiding us? Okay, I'm not even... This is other people's problems.
Yeah. Oh, we might be able to... Oh, is it a different place in the Empire? Or is it actually us?
Oh, it might be a different place in the Empire.
It'll say... if you pause it, it'll say in the diplomacy section. The little axe with the fire.
The axe with the fire.
On the character page where the allies show up.
Oh, yes, I see. Oh, yeah, he's just raiding VHRE.
All right, well, hopefully we'll be safe or we'll lose some gold.
I'm not terribly worried. Okay, our armies are growing. We have migraines. When they hit, my vision seems to shrink, all sight and light winnowing out until there is just a small corner of the world left to me, forever at the edge of focus and underscored by a wellspring of pain.
We should make sure we're disrupting schemes because we might be being poisoned.
Oh. Yeah, we are disrupting schemes right now. But yes, we might be being poisoned. Oh! This is us. This is our army. These are our allies on the way. 3,000
awesome.
Men.
3,000 men strong, you say?
3,000 men strong by sea, Keith. Led by Bertolt Block.
Bertolt Block himself?
Bertolt Block himself has come from the north. Oh, yeah, look. You better run. Oh, my God. Great work, Bertolt Block.
Great work. Great work, quick work.
Yeah, done. That's how it's done. Now we're
it
all
It pays
gonna...
to have allies with 3,000 troops.
Yeah,
truly.
It's going to be very useful for Hungary.
Yeah, extremely.
Because it only costs 150 to bring him into a war, and think of the prestige that we're going to get when we take Hungary.
Yeah, that'll be huge. I mean, just the prestige from this little duchy is like 300, I think.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, I think he's going north to fuck those guys up.
He is, yeah. Yeah, that's good. Sometimes the AI is a little wonky about this.
Ooh. Yes, accomplished forger, finally.
This is really what we've been working towards.
Yeah. Great. Cool, very happy with this. This is going to be very useful. My hostage, Waldo... seemed to enjoy our latest feast immensely. Afterwards, he couldn't stop talking about the feelings that locking eyes with one of the younger servants had caused in him. Oh, the young rascal is coming of age. Notice how true value lies in the expensive trappings of power. I will show him how to make friends at a feast. Now, I could be a good teacher, but instead, I am so stressed.
Yeah, we're very stressed. Speaking of being stressed, do we have any decisions that we can do that might lower that stress a little bit?
Let's see. Well.
Hey, we can visit a brothel. Look at that.
20 gold? Yep, let's do it. Notify when this decision becomes available, I think is probably a good idea for us. Great. Great. Oh.
Still pretty high, that stress.
Still fairly high.
We should, after this, I think we're probably going to be, after we create the duchy, we then will be making probably something like 7.5 gold per month. And I think our next priority should be a hunt.
Yeah, I think so. Definitely. Get that bear. Lose that stress.
Yeah.
Set our sights on Hungary.
And we might get a nice powerful weapon or something.
Yeah.
From our hunt. Or some trinket.
It'd be good. Like a bear. Our own personal bear.
Our own personal bear.
Come and help us with this siege. That would be great.
Our messenger said that we had some people we could marry.
Oh, family members can get married. Yeah, our son. Lots of sons and daughters can get married.
Lots of sons and daughters, yeah, all around.
Anna is third in line.
I have a... here's an idea. Let's pick our worst son. And find the highest prestige matrilineal marriage that we can dole out.
Matrilineal?
Yeah, get him out of there.
Just that's the end of the sun. Okay, let's see.
Because what we don't want is to, like, be massively fracturing our titles when we die.
It's Malouz.
It's Malouz, yeah. And that's not that big of a surprise.
No. Okay, prestige gain.
Malouzer, more like.
More like Malouza. Oh, my God. Okay. No, we want... Do we want prestige gain or do we want alliance power?
Oh, those are both good. We have pretty decent alliance power as it is.
Yeah, but we want to go for Hungary.
Yeah, that's true.
And
so
Angria has...
Ooh, that's pretty good.
3,000 people.
Yeah, that's not bad.
He is
and then
five,
what about the,
though, and I don't
what
feel
about prestige?
Super duper about that.
Oh, yeah, that's rough. That's rough, yeah.
Prestige would be marrying...
Neither of these. How about number three there? Gunderson or whatever.
Let's see. Murkad Mac Conquer.
Oh, wait. Did it... I think it reset. Go back again. Do resort by prestige gain. I think that it, like, messed up. Or... I
sure
swear it messed
us
up.
To marry the 53-year-old Vac Tank. Wow.
Hi, my name's John Johns.
We get 600 prestige. No, he'd get 600 prestige. Not us. He'd get 600 prestige.
Oh, right. So alliance power it is.
Yeah. So our options first are a 5-year-old old
or the 1-year-old our granddaughter. So his niece, I guess.
Oh, my God.
How about this duchess? Awful. How about Steiermark there?
Okay. How much?
16 or 20 and 12?
23,000 people.
Okay, that's not bad.
The 23,000. 2,300 people.
Yeah.
What and, would this be like? Ugh, it's very good with this 5-year-old.
It is good with the 5-year-old.
But I'm not going to do that. Also, they are related.
Oh, okay, yeah. Well, that's bad.
So Duchess Richvara it is, and we want it to be a matrilineal marriage.
We should
marriage.
Make sure that they're not, like, part of Hungary. Because that would be bad.
That's who, a who, great who, call, who's this person? They're part of the HRE. They're from Steiermark.
Oh, okay, great.
Which is... Oh, hang on. Oh, they're right on the edge of Hungary.
Let's make sure they're not de jure part of Hungary.
They are de jure part of the HRE in Bavaria.
Okay, great.
Okay, cool.
So when we have our great war, they will be very close by. Yeah, that's fine. It's better than five.
It's better than five. Yep. Alas, Crusader Kings.
It's Crusader Kings. It's only as good as you can get.
Yeah. And that's a good allegiance.
Yeah.
Okay. Grim. Fucking grim. Okay, well. God, think of how rich we're about to be, and rich with alliances. That's a good point. Why aren't we just making alliances through marriage, Keith? With.
I mean, that's what we should be doing, and we just did it.
Like, but, like, for example, we have this 4-year-old.
Yeah.
And we could arrange a marriage with an alliance power to...
Yeah. Well, there's a balance because you don't want to be giving away all of the people because you will want them to be in your court having children to populate your country.
But we already have lots of children.
Yeah, we have lots of... We have too many children. We could stand to lose a couple more children.
It sucks that this potential alliance by marrying my daughter to my granddaughter is so good, but I'm not going to do that. <That's> a...
Who is our granddaughter's liege? It's just us. So it's not a real marriage. It's
no,
not
it
a
would
real
be
alliance,
because,
I mean.
because.
Oh, it's Duke Herman. Oh, okay. I see.
Of Carinthia. It would be a Carinthian marriage.
Comrade asks, did we ever find that one kid we lost? I think that kid died.
Alas. Oh, we got him.
Nice. We got him. Lock him up.
Well, now we could try and ransom him, but I think
because if we ransom him, then it'll restart the war.
Yeah. Okay.
So we ransom him as part of the enforced demands. So be it.
This is great.
This is really fantastic news. Great job, everyone.
Great job, everyone. Now, I'm actually going to move my marshal to fix the county control in Cagliari because of this silver.
And we should disband our army.
Oh, yeah, true. Okay, where is this? It's here. Yeah. You can't upgrade it currently, but oh my god, look at how much it gives us when we upgrade it.
Yeah, it's huge. Yeah, it's huge. It's really good. Yeah, so right now we've got a gold penalty because of low control, but once that goes up.
Yeah.
Any other prisoners we can ransom off? We just need 70. We're so close.
I know. We should go check out with the Pope again.
The Pope will be like, too soon.
No prisoners.
Okay, that's fine. And we're already doing control.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's going to go really well.
Yeah. Hey, our gold's already going up. Look at that. 5.2.
Oh, God, we're going to be so rich.
Hey, at the start of the stream, we were making like 3.3 or something like that. Huge, huge.
Dentenstein points out, you've got to revoke the holding with the mine now, too. Yeah, the mine isn't the main holding in that county, so you don't get it. Oh.
How do we do that?
Do that. You can revoke from barons for free, but we can't revoke it from her. We don't have limited crown authority.
Let's check out our crown stuff. Can we go to the green, to the realm tab? Can we do that?
Yeah, we can.
Boom.
They won't like it, but...
No, but it needs to be higher anyway.
Yeah. Okay, there goes our prestige. That's fine.
That's fine.
Now...
you're about to get 300 of that anyway.
We're going to revoke her title. She doesn't like us. We have
also
it.
Also fine. Will accept. Done. 7.2.
Okay, 7.
Look at that.
2. Holy hell.
Great tip, whoever told us about that.
Now, they do want to do a Liberty faction, but we have so many soldiers.
And we have tons of allies. They will all come and help quash that.
Yeah. Yeah. Not worried about that at all. Protecting against factions. Fuck you, Crusader Kings. We'll be fine.
We'll be fine. Hey, let's look at the faction just in case. Let's just take a look, little gander at it.
Oh, nothing.
Nothing.
It's Marianu.
Who is this?
It's this guy.
Oh, it's Marianu.
Yeah,
and what does he want? What is... just a quick little temperature check. Just check real quick. What does he want there? What is that? What is, first of all, what is, oh, that's maybe faction. Is that what is the little thing next to minus 100? It's like a little, little picture.
He feels he's a minority vassal. He feels that his faithful culture is marginalized by the liege. And
so he's going to hate us until we can convince him to convert.
Yeah.
Maybe we can convince him to convert.
We're not swaying the Pope. It's not happening.
We did once.
And another thing, you vile bampot, shrieks Agnes, laying into Count Bruno for what must easily be their third screaming match of the day. Okay, the courtiers are bickering. But it did say crimes of passion, which makes me wonder. Oh, is it time for a hunt and then we should call it for today?
It might be time for a hunt. Oh, it's not time for a hunt because what we need to do first is become a Duke of Sardinia.
Yes, you are quite right.
Then it's hunt time.
Duchy of Sardinia. Look at this. Yep, gives 300 prestige, costs 200 gold.
And then we should be able to do a hunt right after.
No.
Look at that. 8.5.
Oh my god. Okay, hybrid cultures are formed. We can pledge allegiance to our liege. We can pay homage. No, I don't think we need to do that. Sardinia.
No, we don't need to do something like that.
Where is Argau? Oh, no. Alsace. Oh my god. Okay, let's see. Decisions. Oh no, it's the quickest way is up here. The bear is gone.
Oh yeah, it was only 3 years and it took us a little while to get our stuff organized, huh?
Damn.
That's a shame. Hey, maybe we could still find a bear.
That's true. Jenny Size in the chat says, great thing about that lower crown authority faction. Now that you have the barony, you can just give them what they want. That's true. We could do that. Oh my god, the first crusade is about to begin.
We'll not be participating in a silly thing like that.
No, we have our own game and it's called Extremely Long Alsace.
We're too busy taking over Europe to help you take over the Middle East.
Jenny Size says you could move your capital to the silver mine, so your heir definitely inherits it.
Ooh, very smart.
Ooh.
We would be abandoning our roots, but...
Fuck it.
Fuck
How do
the
we
roots.
Do this? Fuck the roots.
Long live the branches.
How do we do that?
It is on this page. Oh, we were just have been overwhelmed by stress because our friend died.
Henrik died. A lady, I don't know who she is.
That's our friend. We made friends with her.
Oh. Oh, she was our chancellor.
Our chancellor.
And our current best chancellor is Jakob von Friedenthal.
And I've heard great things.
I have heard great stuff about Jakob.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, how do we move our capital?
I think we have to click on Iglesias, which is where the mine is,
oh,
right?
Oh, it's the up arrow crown. Yeah, move county capital.
Is it, well, just to double check, it is this one, right?
Yeah,
it's
yes,
not
the mine
Cagliari. Okay, yeah. Okay, great.
Okay, great. Got to make Iglesias the county capital and then the realm capital. We can do that.
Yeah.
Ruling the multicultural duchy of Alsace often comes with its own set of challenges. We're practicing learning our languages, but we can't because we are so stressed. Swabian is clearly superior. Move realm capital here.
Swabian supremacy out of sheer self-preservation.
Oh, that actually lost us money. That's interesting.
Hmm.
We lost 0.5 money because some buildings in Strasbourg have become inactive.
Interesting. Slightly, very slightly less money. We're still like way up.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not terribly worried, and we can develop these places. We are making so much money, Keith.
Hand over fist.
Hand over fist, we're making money. This is incredible. This is the capital of Alsace. It's now in Sardinia. We're not swaying the Pope. All right, let's go on a hunt. Average cost 120. Oh my god, we have a new bishop because our bishop died.
Not friends with our bishop, so that's fine.
Yeah, yep, we're okay. I'm not going to send my daughter as a hostage. No. But I will go on a hunt. Okay.
So, unfortunate that we don't have the legendary sighting anymore, but I think that we do a regular deer hunt. The falconry stuff doesn't seem as applicable as the deer hunting stuff.
No, no. And we should do a hunt in Ardara. And
yeah,
our
sure.
goal is to lose stress.
I agree.
Activity options.
And I don't think we even need any of the travel protection.
No, but we could increase.
I think we shell out on that stuff. Yeah.
Because we can afford it. No, we can't.
Because we can afford. Well, we okay.
Now we can.
Yeah. Hey, if we just hang out on this screen for a few seconds, we can.
Yeah, that's very, very
unpaused.
True.
What is it? We need 200 total?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're like, that's just a couple months.
Yeah. Oh, nearly there. Missing 7 gold. Oh.
Missing just 7 gold.
Just
a paltry 7.
There we go. I'll be hosting a hunt in Ardara.
Nine
Nothing like a good old-fashioned hunt. Bruno? Remember the guy we gay married to the other guy who we didn't care about?
Yeah, he's plotting against Agnes, another person we don't care about.
Yep. Okay, fine.
Okay. Yep, brooding fiend, sure.
I think Agnes is our marshal. Waldo's come of age. Well done, Waldo.
Bye.
No, he's still our hostage, I think, but...
Oh, okay. Oh, we've gained a loyalty hook on our... Oh, time to go home. Look at that.
Yeah, I'll send him home.
Yeah, bye.
Bye, Waldo.
It was great to raise you instead of your dad so that we could get a little bit more prestige.
Yeah, just a wee bit. Okay, all right, check my gear. Hunt's going to begin soon. Everybody's getting ready to go. How exciting.
Very exciting. I hope that we get a... Oh.
Oh my god, look at our money, Keith.
I know, it's wild. Fully half of that is coming from Iglesias.
I know.
This was a great plan.
Yeah. Fantastic plan. It's only going to get better as the county control goes.
I know, and I can't believe how well everything's been going. There have been some stumbling blocks, but largely a very successful playthrough.
Yeah. No.
People keep asking us to give them our family. I don't understand why anyone would say yes to that.
Well, if it helps you get hungry.
If you're not hungry, just wait a little bit.
Well, we've unlocked Diplomat, which gives us some cool
Very
stuff.
Nice.
Diplomat boosts our personal schemes. People like us more. We have a higher diplomacy. It's great. Very happy with that.
Do we want to switch over to one of these other trees or to somewhere else? Yeah, this is what I was wondering. I think that there's some stuff in family and August that might be worth our time.
Taxman, collect taxes effectiveness 25% more. Let's see. Monthly prestige per dread.
I think that would be a great one to do once the game has sort of caught up with how much money we're making.
Yeah.
And like we're not like totally drowning in money anymore.
Each friend adds negative 5% stress gain. That might be interesting.
Yeah. Another good one would be, it's too late for that, but under the learning tree has pedagogy is really good.
Where's that to? Yeah, we could stack those two, right? The get friends and...
But it's tough because you've got to be... Once you change focus, you have to wait 5 years before changing again.
Yeah. Yeah, let's see. What's our next option here? It's firm hand, monthly prestige per dread, monthly prestige per knight.
Yeah.
I want to get this. I want to get confidants.
Okay. What about heart of the family? Is that anything?
Let's see. Heart of the family.
It's
close family opinion plus 15. Not really.
No. All our family likes us. That's really good if you are doing stuff that makes your family hate you a lot.
Yeah.
All right, let's hunt and then call it.
Yeah, that sounds good to me. The hunt is going well. Folks are arriving. We're waiting on two people before we begin. Who hasn't arrived yet?
Who dares be late?
Duchess Adelaide and why has the Pope appeared? Oh, and Count Bruno. The Pope is not swinging. Oh, wait, what? Now, hang on.
Someone that we wanted to die.
Have not always been to my advantage. God knows that I was cursed the day I met Melisande. Today, however, that curse has been lifted. Fate has smiled upon me and brought that brooding darkseid to her grave.
Great. I don't know who this is, but I hated them.
She is like a witch.
I hated her. Witch. Whoever this is.
Yeah.
Oh, did we try to become a witch and we made her mad and she became our rival?
I think something like that,
I have a vague memory of this.
Grundin's assembled. Okay.
Grundin's assembled.
Grundin's assembled. What do we want to hunt?
I think we do the best one.
Yeah, middling. With vim, a wolf.
Why I came to hunt stag? Why was that in a game of stress increase? Oh, patient.
There were no stag. Yeah.
Okay.
As we amble in a group, I hear Countess Georgia behind me, hissing from atop her hunting steed. Look at that worthless fop doodle. She points at my acquaintance, Count Otto, who seems to be having a hard time bearing the insults.
Look at that vain Popinjay.
Child and will be punished like one. This is no way for a countess to act.
Okay.
What does mediator do? Oh, boost our diplomacy. Ha, Otto has gone red as a beet. Yeah, let's do this.
Yeah, sure. The same thing. Look at that. Do you want to do the other one?
But a new insult. You're acting like a child and will be punished by one. Countess Georgia gains tasted the belt.
We beat her up.
No. Same thing again. God, what if she just insults someone again? Countess Marianu sees the wolf. Okay. After it, we ride, you will gain 75% prestige. You attempt to corner the wolf with your spear. The method is more perilous. You gain 18 stress. Steady, mind the ravine. You attempt to corner the wolf's spear. The method is more perilous. You gain 18 stress because you are arrogant.
God, we have the absolute worst combination of qualities.
We should go after it.
But we need to lose stress. We're right on the cusp.
No, we got a bit, right? Next is at 200.
No,
we're at
no, it's but we need to go below one or we'll get like a permanent penalty.
Yeah.
There are stress builds that the whole point is like getting bonuses from having high stress.
My useless vassal crouches in the leafy bushes ahead of me, fully concentrating on the approaching dog. I glance around surreptitiously. This might be the best opportunity I get.
Wow!
We
oh my
kill
god!
Countess Georgia. Or no, this is not the time, and we gain 18.
But 100 piety. No, we've gotta hurt her. Unfortunately,
okay, it's very likely that we will wound her.
Yeah, very likely.
And our involvement may be discovered. Duke Gerhard, is that you, my lord? Countess Georgia glances wide-eyed between the bow in my hand and the arrow lodged in her arm. What were you thinking? Oh gosh, let's get that arm looked at. There's a 50% chance she learns that I tried to kill her and a 50% chance nothing happens. You'd do well to forget this. She learns of your secret, loses 10 opinion of you, and you gain 20 dread. Or, this was an unfortunate accident. Oh dear.
So this is the best one slightly.
Yeah. Okay, did that go well?
I don't know.
We can see in our intrigue, right? Hooks on secrets. Your secrets. Attempted to murder Countess Georgia. Okay, let's not worry about that. We gotta get the wolf.
Yeah.
We watch for the wolf from our concealed bowline. Tensing with anticipation as the flushes cries and
we haven't had a lot of opportunities to lose stress on this
We have not. The gray
dog. I guess
it's the
combination of arrogant and patient. Every time we would be patient and lose stress, we gain stress from arrogance. And every time we would, like, have a good time, we lose because of patience.
Oh, it's a hard life, isn't it?
It's a very hard life. I just wish I was at the brothel.
Hold, he's mine. 23% chance the beast is shot. You gain 50%. 90% chance but wounds someone. A random participant is injured. 57% chance the beast escapes. Marianu has a chance and is very likely that he hits it and gains 50 prestige. Now everyone, loose. The wolf pales under a hail of arrows or run away. It's probably got to be Marianu's, right? Because this isn't going to go well.
I think it's us.
We try.
Yeah, because it doesn't really matter if we... I'd rather us get the bow experience.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's true. I carefully take aim as the wolf charges towards us, paws pounding the dirt. The arrow strikes true. Straight into the beast's heart.
Roll.
Yeah.
Was that 19% chance?
Low 20s, I think. Mental break. Wanton desires. Oh, God. Okay. It feels like I'm constantly being distracted by lascivious thoughts and erotic fantasies. Let nobody but me enter the brothel tonight.
This is so sad. We were like 1 second away from finishing the hunt.
Okay. Yep, there we go. Oh, God. Okay. I'm going to keep a memento, the owner of wolf fangs, and we lose 100 stress because of the hunt.
No, but it doesn't matter because we don't have 100 stress
anymore.
No, I know.
Oh my god, it sucks.
We were literally like 3 days off. God, that's brutal. I mean, I guess there was no penalty to going to the brothel anyway, I guess. But I think it's working towards... I don't know. Maybe we have the worst penalty you can get. It's hard to know.
We've equipped 2 sets of wolf fangs.
Yeah, we just wear them around our neck. We just wear 2 massive wolf paws around our... Or, sorry, yeah, they're fangs. What do they both give? Prestige and combat effectiveness or something?
Minimize stress loss. One boosts our vassal levy contribution from glory hound vassals, and one increases our knight's effectiveness.
All right, not bad.
Yeah, not bad. Well, I mean, that wasn't the greatest thing to go out on, but I think this is a pretty good place to leave it. We're making 11 gold a month. We have 1,000 prestige.
Oh, my God. Hey, we have 0 stress.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think largely we're in a much better place than we were at the start. Even if we didn't take over the Kingdom of Hungary. This is that one ally that they have is the king of the emperor of the Holy Roman Empire. So that doesn't even count.
Shit, we could maybe take him, Keith.
We could if we called all of our allies into the war and they all said yes.
Which they will.
Right. We just barely maybe win if we did a good job. But it's worth a try. Hey, I mean,
tune in next
if you want to save it here and do it at the start of the next one.
I mean, maybe this is the place to try.
Maybe this is the place to try. We could start off with just a wild, hungry run.
Oh, that's invalid because that's a question mark.
Is it time? It is time.
Great. Well, thank you for joining us. This has been so much fun. It is always the best to play Crusader Kings.
Yeah, I just love this game.
And I'm all safely moved now. Is there anything we want to plug? Palisade has been fantastic.
We are on a historic and historic stretch of episodes, I think.
Of good friends at the table.
Yeah. I hold the very beginning of Partisan up as like some of my favorite stuff that we've done. And so doing Palisade, which is the sequel to Partisan, I really liked a lot of what was happening, but it hadn't like hit me the same way that Partisan had hit me. And it took until these last like 7 or 8 episodes, and maybe 9 episodes, just like a wild stretch that I, at some point in the middle of, was like, this is it. This is my beginning of Palisade for Partisan. And it's just been really, really good. So
much fun.
friendsofthetable.net or search Friends of the Table in your podcast app for that. Also Media Club Plus, our Hunter podcast that, once it's over, we'll hand it off to someone else to do a different thing. But we've got 30 more episodes or something.
We got a bit.
I don't know how. I didn't tell anyone this, but I actually expanded how many episodes that we're doing by a couple. There was a couple parts of the Chimera Ant arc that I had us watching like 17 episodes across 2 episodes. Just because of how long it is and because it was a natural feeling break. But I basically took 3 episodes of the show and turned it into 5. So I added 2 episodes to the Chimera Ant arc. And we just released episode 4, and there's right now the plan is for there to be like 43, 44 episodes in total.
It's very exciting.
Yeah. And it's been really fun. So Media Club Plus, anything for you personally? Notquitereal.bandcamp.com maybe?
Yeah. If Bandcamp, oh God, I am just
I know.
Daily depressed and angry about what is being done to Bandcamp by venture capitalists.
I know. I loved/still love Bandcamp.
I mean, yeah, I love Bandcamp still in the sense that it is such a phenomenal resource for finding music and for making money from music. And to see that being squandered first by the CEO of Bandcamp, a man called Ethan Diamond, who sold the company to Epic. And then Epic, who sold the company to what sounds like a clown car disaster of a music business company called SongTrader. Bandcamp currently has a union that is fighting for recognition from first Epic and now SongTrader.
Shocker that they unionized and then were immediately sold by Epic after literally 1 year of Epic owning them.
It's grotesque. It goes beyond, it is difficult for me to say how angry it makes me because I feel like I am cheapening my anger and my frustration through rhetoric. I do not have nice, clean words for saying what a colossal waste this is.
The people who did this should be pulverized.
I think that they should go in the mangler.
Yeah, we should open the mangler and toss them in.
It's just the fucking worst. But I would invite you not to cause this to cause you to boycott Bandcamp. Bandcamp is still ultimately a tool that is being used by people who benefit immensely from your help, and as of right now, has not changed their revenue share splits, although I am keeping an extremely close eye on their terms of service. Yeah. If you're wondering in terms of the current licensing and revenue share, it remains the same as it was.
It used to be better. Pre-Epic, it was actually the original Bandcamp ownership that changed the split from like 93% to like 87% or something.
Yeah. Yeah. It's just, you know. But you can go to notquitereal.bandcamp.com and buy my music there. You can also check out the Hallow Stream, which is a yearly Halloween LP that my partner Kat and I are doing at their Twitch, twitch.tv/catbamkapow. This year we are playing Rose Engine's incredible horror game Signalis, which is if Never Silent Hill met Annihilation set on a research facility on a snowy planet. It's incredible. And you can also check out...
What year is that from?
2022.
Okay.
You can also check out Janine, who has been doing her incredible yearly Witching Hour streams here at Friends at the Table. She has been playing Kingdoms of Amalur this year, which is a game that I always mean to go back to and never do.
I haven't played the Re-Reckoning, but when the original one came out, I played it all the way.
A really good time with Kingdoms of Amalur. It's a game of its time, for better and for worse, but often for better.
Yeah. Let's see. I'll plug Run Button again, the Digimon World Let's Play that we just finished after almost 11 years. We did the first half of it in like 3 years, and then very slowly, the game is broken in a lot of really interesting ways. And one of those ways is that the discs just break eventually. Huh. And so we went through 4 discs to beat this game. Including the very final boss, we were getting a disc read error until I bought a new disc and put it in. And it really is
wild.
Like every disc has a part of the game that it just won't play. And so you need to get a new disc.
That is bizarre.
It's bizarre. And the way I've described it, Jack, I don't know if you've heard this from me before. You were checking on Kat last time I said this today. But it's like, you know, the Pokemon rumors about like, there's a Mew under a truck, or there's like surfing Pikachu if you do this weird thing, or if you fly here and go there. Just like weird rumors about how the game works. Everything about Digimon World is like that.
That's like amazing.
It is full of a bunch of systems, and none of the guides are right. All of the FAQs are wrong. Everyone has different and conflicting information on how to do anything. It is a bizarre game to try to navigate. And that's
wonderful.
Another reason why it took us.
And luckily,
10 and a half
you
years.
Have a nice, concise LP of it, right?
Yeah. I mean, we really took only just over the recommended time to beat for like critical path. I think howlongtobeat.com has. 34 and a half hours is their like main story only completion time, and we took like 40 and a half hours, so we were 6 hours over their like minimum.
That's incredible.
Average even though it took us 11 years to do.
That's so good.
And stands as a wild time capsule of
imagine.
I was, when we started that, I was 20 and now I'm 31.
Wow.
Which is weird, super weird. So there's that. There's also friendsofthetable.shop and runbutton.shop. Anything else? All of this stuff goes up on youtube.com/friendsofthetable. If you're a fan of these streams and you miss some stuff, you can go there to check things out. I think that's it.
I think that's about it. Thank you so much for coming out, everybody. And we'll see you next time.
Yeah. Oh, friendsofthetable.cash, just to... That's our Patreon. That's what lets us do all the different things that we do. None of us would have any time to do even 5% of the stuff that we do if it wasn't for Friends of the Table.cash. And we're pretty consistent about doing new and fun and cool things when money goes into that, because it quite literally buys us time from the other parts of our lives.
Yeah, definitely. All right. Well, we'll see you soon.
Yeah, bye.
Bye.